Speed.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live. It's the live Saturday edition. You're invited to join us here toll free. We'll give you the numbers and our Skype here in a moment. We're actually going to start out the show with a special guest, Ademo Freeman, the founder of copblock.org. We'll get the latest from him on why he's going to be turning himself in to the police coming up on Monday. We'll get you that here. Plus, Ben Carson, the Republican guy running for, president, he is a total prohibitionist and wants to ramp up the war on drugs. Would love to get those comments from him here in a few moments. Also, want to welcome our newest official affiliate in Charleston, South Carolina, WTMA 1250. Finally, officially on board with Free Talk Live.
Awesome.
We've actually been on the air there for 2 years now on weekends, on Saturday and Sunday nights live. We used to be on a different station in that market, and when the other station let us go, I was able to, I think they reached out to me. It's been so long, I don't even recall. but I was grateful because WTMA has been taking us on both days on the weekends. We used to be Saturday only in that market many years ago, and so now Charleston listeners have been able to listen to us on Saturday and Sunday nights live, which is awesome. And now we can officially recognize that the station exists. It's on our affiliates list now and everything, so we finally got the signature taken care of. This is sort of like inside radio, I realize that, but Cumulus Broadcasting is the company that owns the station, and their CEOs got blown out the door recently, and then all of a sudden, things started to work again behind the scenes at the corporate level in Cumulus. So It was a good change, I guess. So welcome aboard.
Good for us, at least at that moment.
Yeah, welcome back, Charleston listeners. Of course, you're welcome to participate in the show and bring up whatever you want, even if you're not in Charleston. Wherever you are around the world, we're here to talk to you about whatever's on your mind. Ademo Freeman, to start things out, from copblock.org. You're in Ohio tonight on the Mac Tour, the Mobile Accountability for Cops. You've got an RV. You named it Mac. You and Brian Sumner have been touring around for a few weeks now, actually having kicked off, I think, from Indiana, was it? Where you actually ended up getting warrants because you went to chalk the police station in Noblesville, Indiana. You chalked some pro-police accountability messages, and the cops didn't like that very much, did they, Ademo?
No, that's right. On one of the first pre-stops, I guess is what it was, the first official stop was in DeKalb, Illinois. But on the way there, from our departure out of southern Ohio, we made a pit stop in Noblesville, Indiana, kind of a suburb of Indianapolis, as you mentioned, and met up with some Indiana cop lockers and decided to go down to the police station and do some spontaneous chalking. As you had mentioned, myself and Brian are doing the Mobile Accountability for Cops tour, coplock.org/Mac, for folks who want to see more about that. But just before this happened, we had picked up some new liquid chalk, and some folks who had followed our adventures from the start or for a while know that we like to use children's chalk to chalk what you call pro-police accountability messages outside of police stations. And we do this because it's cheap, it's effective, it doesn't cause damage, and technically it shouldn't be illegal. Brian and I have both chalked, you know, dozens and dozens of police stations, and you know, very rarely do we have some circumstances. At the most that it's been for me in the last couple of years is a ticket. But Noblesville, Indiana, seems to be a little more upset about the liquid chalk, and it's slightly more difficulty in removing from the concrete, and therefore issued criminal mischief charges for Brian and I both. And with those charges came a warrant, and last weekend, or 2 weekends ago now, I was arrested last weekend, about a week today, I was arrested in Kansas City, which is how we were made aware of these charges.
Yeah, you know, one of the things that this brings up for me is just sort of the poor customer service that you often get out of policing organizations. Generally, bad customer service comes with monopolies, and police agencies are, you know, the organizations that basically claim a monopoly. They're part of a cartel, but they, you know, they divvy up the spaces. And what they're, you know, this problem, if there's a problem, could be solved via Skype. You know, we could have a remote hearing where you pipe in. And it's like, okay, exactly what's the problem? Oh, well, that's really like there are damages and it costs $200 to fix it. You want to fine me $400? You know, whatever. Like, you could negotiate and do all these things remotely rather than having to drive halfway across the country in order to satisfy some silly warrant.
Well, that's right. I mean, you're totally correct about the monopolies and how poor of a service they provide. I do want to make it clear that we're voluntarily driving ourselves across the country. They're not ordering us, and we're doing so because we believe that these charges are vindictive. You know, if it really was about the $400 or correcting our behavior, there would be other means to go about that. And one of those would have been to arrest us the night they interacted with us afterwards to hold us accountable for our actions right away. Or, as you mentioned, you know, send us a bill, take that to collections. I don't think prisons and jails were built for such things. Yet they chose to do the warrants. They chose to put those warrants into a federal database so that any officers outside of Indiana would see them. And I believe those actions are proof that it's vindictive. They don't really have intentions of having us pay the money, or it's not its primary goal to get us into a cage. It's to disrupt the MAC tour so that every state we would go into, we would either have to like turn ourselves in or could be stopped, or worse off, if we are driving with all our property, the RV, the car on the trailer, and we get pulled over with us both having warrants, our property would be subject to search and or impoundment. And whether or not we're guilty or innocent, those fees have to be paid. And so Brian and I both feel that at the end of the day, it's best to turn ourselves in. It's best to say to them, hey, this isn't about the money. This isn't about it. It's about what we wrote. It's about accountability. It's about freedom of speech. And we're not going to get any fair justice here. So hold us in your cage for as long as you want to not have to send men with guns after us anymore. You know, neither one of us is going to pay the fine, and neither one of us is going to admit that we're going to be remorseful for what we did. So
now, okay, so a technical question here on how you're going to handle this. You're going to Noblesville, Indiana, which is where the warrants came out of in relation purportedly to the chalking event. You're going to turn yourselves in, but how will that allow for, I mean, it's you and Brian Sumner. There's not a third guy in the vehicle. So I guess, you know, are you going to turn yourselves in at the same time, or are you going to go first and then you're going to sit for a while and then Brian's going to turn himself in? Because is there somebody on the outside who's going to be able to kind of, I don't know, report back to the viewers, if you will, the readers over at copblock.org/Mac?
Yeah, well, we have been spending the last few days not only making our own videos, and one of those videos was an experiment with this liquid chalk and how long it took to remove and how difficult it was. Others were about who are they protecting in relation to this case. And then most recently, our video about going to jail. So we are going to go together. We are going to turn ourselves in together. And that's because the MAC tour is both of us. And so having one person with a warrant and one person without still isn't a winning situation for us.
Right.
We have made arrangements to have people at least try to film. I'm not too sure about which court this will be in or how they are with that. Hopefully, we don't have to make a stance on that issue, but I know I personally will. I'm not going through any court hearing that isn't being filmed by any media access, especially if it's being denied without my knowledge. So that'll be another thing. So, I mean, basically for us, and myself particularly, it's if they're going to give me a megaphone and a platform, then I'm going to talk about as many issues from that platform and with that megaphone as possible. It starts with freedom of speech and chalking public property, which in itself is an issue, freedom of speech, then public property, tragedy of the commons. And if we want to talk about the justice system or lack thereof that it brings, we can do that too. And I plan to bring it all up before we ever get to a guilty or not guilty verdict.
All right. So, and you've got guys in Noblesville, like cop blockers are there who can kind of help you guys out with the recordings and things like that?
There are a few. Still encouraging folks. If they want to come out, Monday we'll be turning ourselves in. Tuesday or Wednesday will probably be the first hearing. And then after that, I just want to be clear too, in those early hearings, like my bond hearing, I might not be as stringent on the recording, but the ones that are set, that are planned ahead of time, that can definitely have due notice, then I definitely plan to hold firm with that. But other than that,
all right. So here's my plan. So I'm going to send you.
How are you going to hold firm when you're in jail?
He can do that. He's been in jail before.
Ride it through.
Yeah. This is nothing.
Well, it's my opinion, Mark, that the max sentence for this is 6 months and a $1,000 fine. Now, I don't know if Indiana is like New Hampshire, where they give you $50 a day for sitting.
You'll find out.
We'll find out. Exactly.
All right. Stand by. Ademo Freeman, thanks for the call here tonight. I'm going to talk to you off the air. This is Free Talk Live.
Obtaining a pre-approval can be a buyer's advantage. This is Charlie Sunstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. In recent years, mortgage guidelines have been tightened. A pre-approval that's been issued by a mortgage underwriter gets you through the process and uncovers potential pitfalls long before you become obligated by a purchase contract. Obtaining a pre-approval will allow you to be certain about the price range that's best for you. You'll know how much cash you'll need to bring to close, and you'll know what your maximum monthly payment will be. Understanding your limits will help you negotiate with confidence. Plus, since sellers like a sure thing, you may have an advantage over buyers who do not yet have a pre-approval. At Van Dyke Mortgage, we work hard to be your trusted advisor and can help analyze your personal situation and give you advice that matters. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com. That's VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
Thousands of people seeking home security get ripped off every day, and the home security industry wants you to believe that's your only option. They've got hordes of salesmen out there trying to scare you into signing one of their long-term contracts. You get stuck writing huge checks month after month with no way out. It's robbery by contract, and it can cost you thousands. But there's a better way to protect your home. SimpliSafe Home Security. SimpliSafe has no contracts. None. You'll get award-winning 24/7 protection. Security professionals watching over your home, ready to instantly send police to the rescue. For just $14.99 per month. That's less than half what most companies charge. Protect your home the smart way. Visit SimpliSafeDefense.com today for an exclusive 10% offer and get a free keychain remote worth $25. Only when you go to SimpliSafeDefense.com. SimpliSafeDefense.com.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the live Saturday edition of the program. You're welcome to join us here, and you can bring up anything that you want. Again, 855-450-3733, 855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number. We've also got Skype. You can sound as good as Ademo did a few moments ago. He was on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. And, you know, we all use the internet these days, but we really don't get to use it the way it was meant to be used, anonymously and without oversight. Fortunately, ProXPN is here to solve that. It's a virtual private network that encrypts all of your online data before it gets to your internet service provider. ProXPN offers OpenVPN, the gold standard of network encryption, and they've got apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, plus there's Linux support as well, so setup is super easy. Doesn't matter if you're using your smartphone or desktop or laptop computer, you can get ProXPN.
Also, and you can use it on different devices. You can have the same account, different devices.
Yeah, that's true as well, and they've integrated Nonkly.com to mask your emails. If you get a premium account, they've got more servers than ever before, giving you greater speed and security, and probably most importantly, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever. They take credit card and even Bitcoin. Plus, if you use code FTL50, you'll get 50% off of the regular monthly price for the lifetime of an annual account. It can end up being cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. Go to proxpn.com right now. Use the internet the way it should be used. Go to proxpn.com and use code FTL50. Take back the privacy that is your right. As we continue here, you're welcome to comment on what you want. Just a further thought here regarding Ademo, the founder of CopBlock.org. He is going to turn himself in. Also, Brian Sumner, his partner on the CopBlock Mac Tour, will be turning himself in Noblesville, Indiana, coming up Monday morning. They are looking for folks who are interested to visit CopBlock.org/Mac. That stands for Mobile Accountability for Cops. That's CopBlock.org/Mac. And they suggest calling the jail on a daily basis once they turn themselves in, as well as prosecutor James Baldwin. And I presume that contact information is over at copblock.org/Mac. So that's a way that you can help from the outside to put pressure on these bureaucrats to let our friends go sooner rather than later. Because no bureaucrat wants his phone ringing all day long with concerned members of the public trying to talk to them.
Yeah, this really is throwing some people into the machinations of the bureaucracy of the the jail industrial complex that we have in this country for really no particularly good reason.
And it's all over chalking. And so it's a freedom of speech issue. It's real cut and dry to me. So it's going to be very interesting to see this as it develops. And I did give Ademo our studio landline here, which he can call when he's on the inside. So maybe we'll hear from him when he's inside the Noblesville jail. Ben Carson, of course, would love to put Ademo in jail. He is one of the Republican presidential candidates, and I imagine he's not very different from many of the other Republican candidates. This article just happens to be about him in the area of the war on drugs.
He's, to some extent, supposed to be sort of an outsider, right? Like, he's not a there's that, but he's not a career politician.
Is he, a doctor?
He's a doctor. He's a brain surgeon.
Okay.
He happens to have more melanin in his skin than I do, which is, fine. I think that that's great that Republicans can put up a black candidate who's going
to
be leading.
And what is he, second place to Donald Trump or something?
It looks like in some polls he's beating him.
Really? Okay.
So, anyway, it really, that's besides the point. We're talking about his position here, and his position is he wants to intensify the war on drugs in order to, I guess, stamp out this this national health issue we have of meth and whatever, decades ago it was crack. It just changes. The addictions change, but the amount of people who are addicted, it doesn't. And so what we can find here is that it seems like, maybe this war on drugs isn't working.
Well, apparently he thinks it's working great, but it could work better if they put more money and government hours and time into
it. I've heard that many, many times when it comes to government programs. It doesn't sound small government to me at all.
If elected president, this from Connor Friedersdorf over at theatlantic.com, Ben Carson won't just continue to wage the perennially failing war on drugs. Like all of his predecessors in both parties since Richard Nixon, he would intensify the failed policy. Because, well, better to quote him directly. Here's the hard-to-follow reasoning that he offered in an interview with Glenn Beck. And didn't Glenn Beck kind of come on board with more legalization kind of stuff?
Glenn held his feet to the fire.
Okay, good to know. Oh, so you've heard this interview already?
Yes, I watched it.
Glenn Beck says, "Do you continue the war on drugs?" Carson replies, "Absolutely." "You do? I intensify it." "Well, let me ask you a question," says Beck. "I mean, it doesn't seem to be working now and ever." I'd like to add, Carson says, "Yeah, well, go down to the border in Arizona like I was a few weeks ago. I mean, it's an open highway, and the federal government isn't doing anything to stop it." unquote.
I don't know what that has to do with the war on drugs, but...
I think he's referring to drugs coming across the border.
Well, I would imagine drugs are coming across the border because of supply and demand. And, you know,
but Mark, if you put a bunch of Border Patrol agents in the way, that will disrupt supply and demand, won't it?
If you put a bunch of prison guards in the way, you'd think it would, but it doesn't. The government can't keep drugs out of their own prisons. Mm. How are they going to keep drugs from coming across the border?
What if you put more prison guards?
If they stop every drug from crossing the border, the southern border, the drugs will find a different way into the country. When you arrest
fences
a drug...
Fences in the ocean. Going down a mile.
When you arrest a drug dealer, you create a job opening. When you arrest a burglar, when you arrest a murderer, you burglaries and murders go down. A mass murderer, a serial mm-hmm. killer, or whatever. Then you know these crimes go down. However, when you arrest a drug dealer, you've simply created a job opening.
Carson, so Beck says, okay, legalize marijuana, and Carson says, I disagree with it. Now back to theatlantic.com. The implication seems to be the federal government isn't trying very hard to interdict drugs coming across the Mexican border, or that a double border fence that Carson advocates would somehow make the war on drugs a winning proposition. In fact, multiple federal agencies spend billions trying to interdict drugs flowing in from Mexico, and even if the Great Wall of China stretched across the whole southern border, the black market in illegal drugs would continue to thrive.
Yep.
The federal government is not even able to keep illegal drugs out of maximum security prisons. And of course, they are right on, and you are right on about that. The price goes up. You know, the price of drugs in prison is higher quite a bit than the drugs on the street, and the drugs on the street are higher in price quite a bit than anything that's legal. You know, like a bottle of aspirin, you can get 300 aspirin for $5 or whatever, and, you know, obviously you can't get 300 ecstasy tablets for that kind of price because of the black market driving the price up.
Likely the formulation costs for aspirin aren't anything much more than the formulation costs of ecstasy.
Exactly.
Now, there may be issues with distribution. If demand is lower for ecstasy than it is for aspirin, you can expect to see probably costs, you know, because it's a specialized product, then at that right. point costs would go up, that for those sorts of things. Everybody seems to want aspirin. Not everybody wants ecstasy. So, yeah, I don't know what pricing would be. I'm just suggesting it's probably 10 times what it would be now.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt about that. If you look at, look at cannabis, for instance. Now, it's certainly true that in the states where cannabis has been legalized for recreational use, like Washington and Oregon, recently Alaska, Washington and Colorado were first, then Oregon and Alaska came. In those states, you'll see that the prices are lower slightly than the black market, but they're also still highly regulated. So it's not truly a free market in that plant.
They also have more high quality products.
That's correct.
So they're not they're not selling dirt weed.
Can't buy the dirt weed there anymore.
No, they just can't get what they call mids.
855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Do you agree with Carson that the war on drugs should intensify? It's Free Talk Live.
Global warming covertly describes the effects of iron poisoning. CO2 is iron poison blood types and is the body's defense mechanism to buffer the oxygen iron attracts. CO2 in blood and blood type prevalences are used as false evidence for global warming and is the setup for the greatest fraud in history. The healthy blood type AB is on the Shroud of Turin and is their DNA proof they are his Christ. For further information, unveilingthem.com, unveilingthem.com.
The legendary Dr. Joe Wallach, heard on Alex Jones, George Norrie, Benny Hinn, and so many more, is on his 90 for Life tour, and you can see him live and in person Monday, October 26, 6:30 p.m. at the Unity Village, 1901 Northwest Blue Parkway, Unity Village, Missouri. Don't miss this incredible event. Call 615-389-7733 to reserve your seats today. That's 615-389-7733.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, The Seditious Sirens, The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, Tech Guru Brian Sovereign, Cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are welcome to join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. This Ben Carson guy is pretty popular. Mark, could you find, I mean, I know I didn't ask you this a moment ago, but find a poll. I'm just curious to see how he's doing versus Donald Trump. He's very, very popular in the polls. So presumably what this guy has to say about continuing drug prohibition, specifically against marijuana, should be relatively popular. You know, if this guy's popular, then his opinions should be echoed by a number of people. He was in an interview with Glenn Beck recently, and Beck asked him about legalizing marijuana, and he said he wanted to intensify the war on drugs. And we reported last night on Montana. This was a shock, Mark. You'd Friday's off on Free Talk Live, but we learned last night that the Montana medical marijuana program is basically in the process of being reversed. There's a group of activists there who've been working against medical cannabis. There are politicians. The federal government has been doing raids on clinics. They've dropped down from like 30,000 patients to, I think, 3,000.
Wow.
They've dropped from like 4,900 clinics to 400. And I mean, it's just it's really terrible what's happening in Montana. So it's driving people underground. The people that need marijuana for medical purposes, if it works for them, and for a lot of people, marijuana or cannabis is like a miracle drug, they're going to keep getting it, and they'll just risk going to prison.
I'd like to hear the proposal for stopping people from smoking marijuana. I mean, I don't care whether it's recreational or medical. I'd like to hear the proposal, because so far, nothing's worked. I suppose you can lock Americans in cells, but then the guards will smoke marijuana, or they'll give it to... I mean, there's nothing out there. You could cut people's hands off. They'd still smoke marijuana.
And that is a good question. How does Carson want to intensify the war on drugs? If you've got any ideas, 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733. Of course, you know, the typical government solution here is to increase funding, right? He's saying that the border's wide open. well, we need more Border Patrol. That'll solve the problem. As though the Border Patrol agents aren't going to take payoffs to allow loads of drugs to come through the border. You don't think that's happening now? Okay, yep. So you double the number of guards on the border, the cartels will just double the payoffs.
It's a misunderstanding of economics. I'm sorry. That's all it is. If you increase the war on drugs, all you're going to do is increase the pricing of drugs. And so far, what that seems to be for people is that it just means that they spend less money on food and shelter.
Here's another quote from Carson. He said this about marijuana back in 2014. Quote, I think the medical use of marijuana in compassionate cases certainly has been proven to be useful. Okay, so he gets some credit for that. But recognize, he says, that marijuana is what's known as a gateway drug. Which, by the way, Mr. Carson, your own government's study, I believe it was the 1999 Institute of Medicine study, looked at that question and they determined that it was not a gateway drug. That if there's a gateway aspect to marijuana, it's the fact that it's illegal.
Right.
The fact that it is being sold by drug dealers who have an incentive to push other drugs on the customers who are buying the marijuana.
Yeah, I think it's clear that it's a gateway, but it's made a gateway by the government and by illegality of it. When you take what would otherwise be just your average person who wants to alter their consciousness, the same as somebody who, drinks coffee or drinks beer, that same sort of person, who, and then send them into the underground, send them to a drug dealer. That drug dealer is liable to want to increase his bottom line by purveying other sorts of drugs, and they'll introduce them to things that you do not want them introduced to. If this was being taken as a purely practical course, just, which drugs you want your kid doing or something like that, best I can tell, I'm not saying I want my kid smoking pot, but the best I can tell is that people on marijuana don't make as many bad choices as people who are, drunk out of their minds. And when I was in high school, there was more than one instance where I got drunk out of my mind and terrible things happened.
Me too. Let's go to Cliff. He's in Indianapolis listening to WIBC. Hello, Cliff.
Yes, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Ben Carson, I just wanted to make a point with Ben Carson. It's been told that the people who support Bush and are pumping money in support of Ben Carson into dethroning Trump, considering that he would be a weaker candidate. But my question is to you, with as far as drugs, does more drugs availability or legalizing drugs, is that really, how do we take care of those who become addicts, like the alcoholics?
Well, you don't take care of those people by putting them in a jail cell. That certainly doesn't help people with addiction.
That.
You agree, right?
But is that going to be very costly, or the increased use? If you legalize it, does that increase? Because when Prohibition, at the end, the very end of the Prohibition, the use of alcohol had dropped significantly.
I don't believe that.
But it,
what was that?
How do you get those statistics?
I'm a history major, so I know.
How do you get the statistics?
That's true. Well, I could Google it, I guess, and find it, but.
Well, because would people be honest about using alcohol if it were illegal for them to use alcohol? Would they really tell the truth about that?
Yeah, the wineries were selling kits where you could make wine at your house.
Well, that's a variant that wasn't considered, I'm sure.
So one thing I think happened under Prohibition is it broke the back of the consumption of brewed alcoholic beverages throughout the day. At that time, we had a lineage of drinking beer because, you had to do something to the water in order to make it potable because there's a lot of bad water out there. So they would brew beer and people would drink watered down beer all day long. So they'd be at a low level of drunkenness throughout the day. I think that it successfully broke the back of that. However, it also, the consequence of this is that it increased the consumption of liquor, which I don't know about you, but I've made some of my worst decisions. Having drunk, it's liquor that seems to be worse than the beer.
Yeah, we just heard about that in Oklahoma.
Yeah.
Yeah. My concern is that the increased use of drugs, marijuana, it's kind of a mind-bending type of drug. I don't know. I've never tried it, but...
I have. Yeah, let me tell you.
I just wondered if that would increase, additional problems on the road. And,
so, what if it turned out that when you legalized drugs, the use decreased? Would that shock you?
Yeah, it would. Yeah.
What if it turned out further? What if it turned out that legalizing cannabis specifically not only decreased the use among adults but also among teenagers? Would that surprise you?
Yes, it would.
So is that
what's happening? I haven't looked it up.
So I'd like to give you some information here regarding the Netherlands and their experience with experimenting with some level of decriminalization of marijuana. Or outright legalization of it, whatever you want to call their system over there, where it's allowed in coffee shops and sort of tolerated, that has resulted in fewer teenagers using marijuana. That's a fact. Now, for a moment, after it was legalized, it did spike slightly and then went down below the rates at what it was prior to it being legalized. And some would speculate the reason for that being that there's no more forbidden fruit aspect. Once it enters the world of legalization, it's no longer as sexy of a thing to do or an attractive thing to do if it's no longer illegal. At least that's, I think, a good speculation as to why that happened.
Yeah, I'm familiar with that. That's kind of what was talked about back in the 60s. They said that if we legalized it, it would lose its romance.
So consider that, and if you want to research it, my claims, by all means. Another one you might want to look at is Portugal. Portugal actually decriminalized all drug possession, so everything, not just marijuana, but, you know, the hard stuff as well. And it turns out that in Portugal, after more than a decade now of having this decriminalization status, that there are fewer addicts in the Portugal society than there were previously. Like, it's down by 40% addictions. And that's not because they're all killing themselves from overdoses either. It's because they're able to get treatment. They're not afraid to get treatment because it's not illegal to have the drugs. Cliff, thanks for your call and the concerns. And certainly a lot of people are going to have those concerns. But if you want to share your thoughts on Ben Carson wanting to intensify the war on drugs, our number is 855-450-FREE.
Attention. A very wealthy U.S. benefactor now reveals money-making secrets used by the rich and powerful. Credit success secrets once used only at the top levels of business are now being revealed to the general public. Imagine having a business that runs itself, puts money in your pocket so you never have to go to work. Imagine someone else gave you the money to start. Secret groups are pulling for your success by giving perfect scores in both business and personal credit. They show you how to get good credit and how to use good credit. If you have bad credit, no credit, or your credit isn't as good as that other guy's credit, it really doesn't matter anymore. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many get cash in pocket right now. Call now for free information on how Credit Success Secrets Revealed can put money in your pocket so you never work again. Call 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or go to Credit Success Secrets Revealed.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck
stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is down $1 at $1,168 per ounce, and silver is up 5 cents at $15.91 per ounce. Bitcoin is currently trading at $275. Halloween is almost upon us. Give your special ghosts and goblins a treat they won't soon forget, an Australian 1-ounce silver spider. To order yours today, give us a call at 800-874-9760 or online at rrbi.co.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the live Saturday edition. Of course, you can join us on the radio waves. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Your comments welcome on Ben Carson, who is saying he wants to intensify the war on drugs because it hasn't failed hard enough over the, I don't know how many dozens of billions of dollars have been spent over the last several decades, but it's probably in the hundreds of billions at this point. It's insane how much money and how many lives they've wasted on this war on drugs. Police figured it out much earlier
with alcohol prohibition than they have with marijuana prohibition.
I mean, does Ben Carson like having cops shot to death? Because that happens sometimes during drug raids where someone will decide they want to defend their property and their life and they shoot back at the police. And sometimes cops die in these wars on drugs. Really, but for what? To try to stop someone from getting high and they're going to get high anyway? You bust the drug dealer, the drug user's still out there. They still want to get high. They'll find another way.
Well, it also puts innocent people in danger, too, not just police officers.
Yep.
You know, the war on drugs drives up the cost of drugs by at least 10 times, and it may be even more than that. And so when you have these, you know, really expensive drugs that people are addicted to, they're going to have to do crazy things in order to get that money. Sometimes, say, they do burglaries or armed burglaries or things like that, putting, you know, normal families at risk because, well, you know, you happen to come in on one of these people, somebody gets their throat slit, whatever it might be. That's a victim of the war on drugs, a completely innocent victim of the war on drugs. This is a system that hasn't been working for decades.
But if you spend more on it, Mark.
It's been working. It's been working, creating huge, powerful prison guard unions. The drug cartels do real well. Attorneys do real well off of this. Politicians do good off of it.
Everybody else gets screwed.
Yeah, everybody else gets screwed. But lots of people just still glom on to the idea that this is what jail is the only solution. This is it.
It's
all we got. Jail.
Hey, you know what? You can't buy illegal drugs, but you can go to shop.freetalklive.com to get pretty much everything else you need through Amazon and Walmart. There's links there that'll take you to those sites, and when you shop through those links, Free Talk Live benefits. So, great way to get your shopping taken care of, and we'll tell you later how to save big time at Amazon if you've got Bitcoin. But if you don't have Bitcoin, then go to shop.freetalklive.com and enter Amazon through the links you will find there and get your shopping taken care of. Free Talk Live will get a cut when you do that. More comments from Ben Carson about legalizing cannabis, but he also just wants to intensify the war on drugs as a whole.
Generally.
Because, you know how government is. When you spend more on government programs, they just become more efficient.
Yeah, they work better.
Oh, wait, no, they don't. They're still government. They're still completely shielded from the marketplace demand or the you know, the market signals. They are made
public schools cost half of what government schools do per student. That's the end of the story. Any parent wants to
run that by me one more time.
Public schools per student cost half to send a student to a public private school. I'm sorry, a private school.
Private schools cost
half what a government sending a student to a government school does.
Okay.
And any parent out there wants to send their kid to a private school if they could. They generally don't because they're already spending a bunch of money through their taxes on private schools or public schools. Excuse me, I'm getting this all confused. So you know, that's the end of the story. That's it. I mean, you see the economics. It's laid right out there before you.
Kent is on the line, listening in Panama City. Kent, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Yeah, how you doing?
Hey, go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah, well, I would just like to say that it gets the police officers killed and all this, all these victims killed because they put all this war and pressure on these people. It's the demand and the supply. All these people want to get their little fixes on, but the law's in the way, and that's the problem. The law just ought to legalize it, just like some of them other countries done legalize it. Let them just do their drugs, and you'll see they wouldn't have all the big high prices on drugs and the crime. You wouldn't have the crime as much because there's no reason for a person to run on high-speed chases.
Absolutely true. You know? When the prices are not raised artificially due to the black marketplace, then you find affordable product, which means people don't have to rob a liquor store. They don't have to hold somebody at knife point. They don't have to go, you know, break into someone's car and steal their car stereo because they can afford it.
They don't have to do those things. They choose to do those things, but they'll stop choosing to do them.
The war you have over in Mexico with the drug lords and all, the United States created that. They didn't have all that years back in the past. The United States kept putting pressure on Mexico about they were so relaxed. They let people have their drugs and all everything down there. It used to be a relaxed place. But the United States has funded that and encouraged the Mexican government to do the same thing that they've been doing. But they haven't won the battle over here in drugs yet, much less Mexico.
Kent, great call. Thanks for sharing your thoughts tonight. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us here, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Tell us how Ben Carson can intensify the war on drugs and actually have success in it.
Yeah, I'd love to hear any plan for making the war on drugs work, because it isn't an idea that works at all, hasn't yet, and isn't gonna. But I think that it's worth pointing out the prison population. There are people in prison for doing things to get drugs. You were just talking about robberies and these sorts of things. And when those people, I think it's a reasonable guess that you would see a drop in prison population, maybe by 75%. So 75% of the prison population wouldn't need to be. I'm not saying you release them. I'm not making that claim at all. I'm simply saying that if over time without the war on drugs, you wouldn't see as much crime generally.
Yeah,
not just the drug crime, but just general crime.
A drug-related crime, wherein it's because the person is an addict, they are motivated to go and commit crimes in order to fund their habits.
Right. There'll still be some crazy person in the parking lot of, you know, the local fast food joint trying to flip over cars or doing whatever they're doing because they're on some kind of psychotic break from maybe PCP or something. But that's still happening today, already happening.
It's pretty rare, but yeah.
It's rare. It happens every once in a while.
Usually people
this
flipping
is what
cars.
People worry
Usually
about,
Usually people flipping cars are on alcohol.
Right,
these
right.
Days.
That's the thing is that currently you have the most dangerous drug in the world is legal in the United States, and we know how that goes. We can handle it. It's not great.
Yeah, in fact, this weekend was the weekend a year ago that there was someone flipping cars right here in Keene, New Hampshire. There was the Pumpkin Fest riots that were happening, and that was fueled by alcohol.
Yeah, they weren't doing PCP there.
Nope, let's go to your calls and thoughts here. We've got Jeff. He's in Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Hey, Jeff.
Hey, guys, you said the operative word, alcohol and fuel. Alcohol was fuel 100 years ago, and the reason for prohibition, it was such a great lead-in that you said that. John D. Rockefeller funded the Women's Christian Temperance Organization with $4 million, which was a huge amount of money at that time. I think they were a bunch of old bats who nagged their husbands to drink.
Yeah, anyway, they were a real unfun bunch.
Well, so the thing is, Well, okay, meat is a poison, alcohol is the antidote. But what I'm trying to say here is that alcohol was fuel, and farmers raised it for fuel, and the purpose for prohibition wasn't to stop drinking so much. That was a farce. That was just a sham. The reason for prohibition was, there's a guy, his name is David Bloom, I think, and he talks about alcohol can be a gas and stuff, and he's making alcohol for fuel. And anyway, so 100 years ago, we used alcohol for fuel, and I guess Brazil does. But it was all stopped, and it was made a gasoline monopoly. See, John D. Rockefeller had this muck in his coal mines. He was a coal magnate, and the muck was petroleum, crude petroleum. And so he had a scientist find out what they could do with it. They distilled and made gasoline. And so he had a problem, and that was that they didn't need him. And so he had to create prohibition and go around busting up the
I had not heard that story behind alcohol prohibition. It sounds plausible. Well, thanks, Jeff, for telling it tonight. Thank you for that. It wouldn't surprise me at all. We certainly know that the newspaper man, what was his name? The journalist character that was behind marijuana prohibition.
Hearst.
Yeah, William Randolph Hearst. So there's no doubt the DuPont Corporation was also behind marijuana prohibition as well. Well, because, not because drugs are bad, but because those plants specifically were bad for their business.
Well, it's so the whiskey rebellion wasn't fought over car fuel. It was fought over whiskey. And
yeah.
So alcohol was more than just fuel, but we can see clearly that alcohol, for whatever reason, is not the primary thing that makes our cars go. We do have it in to some extent. You'll see gasohol and things like that, ethanol. So I don't know. I think that that might be a contributing factor. I will not accept that.
Yeah, like he said, he funded the temperance movement, right? So he was the underlying motivation for that. Like if they didn't have his money, would they have had the success that they did?
I don't know whether he was the money behind the temperance movement.
Well, that's
okay.
What he said. That was his claim, right?
If that's the case, then I would say that money tends to bring success unless you're talking about the government.
That was his claim. I mean, we haven't verified it, but it sounds like a plausible story. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I mean, we wouldn't mind a mysterious backer funding Free Talk Live. That would help our message, wouldn't it?
People already believe the Koch brothers do.
Where are they anyway? Because they don't actually fund the show. We should get them to fund the show, but they don't. It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. Are you ready to intensify the war on drugs?
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof money to the people where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom in the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, October 24th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.84 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,164 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $282. Antiwar.com reports at least 22 civilians were killed on Friday and another 40 wounded after a suicide bombing against a Shiite religious process in the Pakistani city of Jacobabad. Five of the slain were children, and so far no group has claimed credit for the blast. The procession was commemorating the ninth day of Muharram, a part of the holiday Ashura, which is hugely important for Shiite Muslims. It is also commonly attacked by Sunni Islamist groups across the Middle East, particularly in Iraq, where massive pilgrimages are held. The processions in Pakistan, however, aren't nearly so big, but with ongoing sectarian violence in Pakistan, these smaller processions are still a popular target, despite efforts to make a major show of security by the Pakistani government. Such efforts to secure Shiite targets are common in Pakistan, but usually not very successful, as the various factions seem to find a way to hit these targets, with suicide attackers showing surprising effectiveness at infiltrating such gatherings and causing major casualties. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports the Department of Justice on Friday said no charges are warranted against the Internal Revenue Service following a two-year investigation into claims that the government's tax-collecting arm illegally targeted right-wing conservative groups seeking tax-exempt status. DOJ officials opened the probe in 2013 amid claims that the IRS was setting its sights on applications from conservative groups. The allegations said the agency singled out their applications for extra scrutiny while liberal groups met no such obstacle. On Friday, the DOJ announced it had closed the investigation after finding no evidence of illegal activity by the IRS, its employees, or former official Lois Lerner. Assistant Attorney General for Legislative Affairs, Peter Kudzik, wrote in an 8-page letter on Friday, "Our investigation uncovered substantial evidence of mismanagement, poor judgment, and institutional inertia leading to the belief by many tax-exempt applicants that the IRS targeted them based on their political viewpoints, but poor management is not a crime. We found no evidence that any IRS official acted on political, discriminatory, corrupt, or other inappropriate motives that would support a criminal prosecution." Kudzik also said the investigation conducted by the DOJ's Criminal and Civil Rights Division, the FBI, and the Treasury Department's Inspector General for Tax Administration found no evidence that any IRS official attempted to obstruct justice after the fact either. Lerner, who was held in contempt of Congress last year for refusing to answer the allegations, was placed on administrative leave during the investigation and ultimately resigned in September 2013. She was the head of the IRS's department responsible for processing tax-exempt applications. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerous supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a proposed Alaska bridge that became a symbol of wasteful federal spending on politicians' pet projects has officially been scrapped a decade after the idea was first floated, according to state officials. Dubbed the Bridge to Nowhere, it would have connected the small city of Ketchikan to its airport on nearby Gravina Island, and it secured a $223 million earmark in 2005. Earmarks of nearly $450 million to help finance two proposed bridges produced cries of outrage from opponents who saw them as exemplifying federal waste. Alaska got the money in the end, but the earmarks were lifted. Jeremy Woodrow, Alaska Department of Transportation spokesman, said state officials had studied less expensive bridge options, but opted to pursue upgrading the ferry facilities for those making the 15-minute water commute. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Scary day in Virginia after a mass shooting at the offices of Slash Forward Marketing. Management described the violent scene as incredibly inopportune if the company wants to hit its sales goals.
Gunshots were first heard around 9:40 a.m. VP of sales Ken Miller placed the first 911 call.
911, what's your emergency?
Hello? Someone is shooting everyone at our office. Can you guys do something about this? We really can't afford to lose focus right now.
The alleged shooter, Brian Henderson, a Slash Forward employee, was described by Miller as a so-so salesman and a, quote, candy ass who obviously couldn't howl with the big dogs. Slash Forward management said the company is rattled to the core by this poorly timed shooting.
It was horrible, really. But hashtag pray for Slash Forward is trending, and we are getting tons of media exposure, so I think we're going to survive.
Donations for the families of victims are pouring into the company website, as are applications for the 18 job openings listed immediately after the shooting.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Phones are loaded up. People want to talk about Ben Carson, who wants to intensify the war on drugs. Now, I imagine a number of his Republican cohorts would say the same thing, but I haven't asked them, and so I can't say for sure, but I imagine that they would. And in fact, the Democrats would probably want to intensify the war on drugs. But maybe we are moving in a different direction, at least in the world of cannabis. I mean, there are four states now where it's legal for recreational purposes, which I think is fantastic. And hey, guess what? The world in those states has not caught on fire. Everything's okay in Alaska and Oregon and Washington State and Colorado, where people are able to go to a store and buy the same plant they've been buying through the black market. In fact, buy better versions of those plants, to buy versions that are actually healthier to use in the legal marketplace for cannabis. You can actually buy edibles, which are relatively prolific in the legal marketplace, but hard to find in the black market. You know, your average marijuana dealer just sells pot. You know, they just sell the buds from the plant. They're dried. You put them in a pipe and roll them in a joint and smoke them. But in the legal marketplace, there's candies, there's cookies, there's, you know, all kinds of different things that have been created. There are even, you know, chefs that are creating marijuana-infused pizza and, you know, marijuana-infused fancy dinners and things like that. There's all kinds of creative things that can be done when the marketplace is actually allowed to operate openly. There are also the new concentrates as well, the cannabis concentrates that you can purchase. So one of the big objections to from the drug prohibitionists to cannabis being legalized is that, well, the cannabis today is 20 times stronger than the cannabis when I was using it back in the 1970s, so it's more dangerous now. Well, wait a minute. If it's stronger now, that means you don't need to sit around and smoke it all night long, or at least it's less likely that someone will do that. If you can get the same high by smoking less of it, then isn't that a good thing for people's health? Putting less smoke into someone's lungs, I think, would be preferable to more smoke. Or what if you don't want to smoke it at all? Well, if you're a medical user or if you just don't like smoke, there are other ways to consume. I mentioned the edibles, but there's also the concentrated wax, as they call it, which can be vaporized and then turned into a vapor rather than a smoke, which doesn't have all the particulate matter. It's not arguably not as dangerous to one's health to use a vaporizer, and that's a very popular way to do it for medical purposes. But Ben Carson, he says that it's time to intensify the war on drugs. Do you agree with him? The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to Marla. She's in Montana. Marla, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hello, this is Maria speaking.
Oh, I'm sorry, Maria. I think the call screening software here is a little too small for me, so I think that might actually be a Maria. Are you in Bozeman tonight?
Yes.
Welcome. You're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
Yes, what I wanted to share with you was my personal experience with the veterans. And I worked as a hairdresser for a year.
You know what? I want to hear your experience, Maria, but you're breaking up on me. So I'm going to put you on hold, and I'm going to have my board op check in with you and see if you can get into a better cell. Maybe you're just in a bad cell on the road or something like that. So I do want to get your experience, especially since you're in Montana, where they're actually having a tough time with the medical marijuana program. It is actually being reviewed now by the Montana Supreme Court, and it may basically not entirely be shut down by the Supreme Court, but worst case scenario, they could essentially make it so the care providers can no longer charge for the product, which would basically give them no reason to do business besides, you know, just trying to help people. You know, if you can grow marijuana and give it away, that's cool, but it's going to sort of put a real kibosh on your ability to effectively grow your business and distribute the plant.
Oh, yeah.
So that's essentially what they're looking at there. We'll hopefully get back to Maria here, but let's in the meantime go to Tony in Muncie, Indiana. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Tony.
Hey, good evening. How are you?
Great. Go ahead with your thoughts, Tony.
Well, this is the first time I've ever listened to your show, and you make me want to rip my steering wheel out of my car.
Oh, no.
You guys have said some things.
Don't do that.
Well, I'm not literally. So a little while ago, somebody said that, because I'm a deputy sheriff, somebody said that police are getting killed because of the war on drugs. Because when we do drug raids on drug dealers' houses, that these people are shooting at us because they're protecting themselves and their homes. That's not the way it works. We have probable cause. We've got a warrant signed by a judge to go in and arrest these people and search their houses. They're not shooting at us to protect themselves. Okay.
Well, first of all, Tony,
you don't like the terminology?
Let's be honest here. Most of the people that are that you do a drug raid on never shoot at you. It's very rare that that even happens.
No,
that's
correct.
Yeah, there are 50,000 drug raids in the United States, and most of them are, there are 50,000 raids in the United States per year. Most of them are drug related.
A lot of times when the cops get shot in these raids, it's actually not by a drug dealer. It's when they raid the wrong house, and it's just an average person, like the 92-year-old Catherine Johnston in Atlanta, Georgia, who was having her home raided by these scary armed men coming in, kicking in her door, shouting. She's awoken from a dead sleep. She grabs her revolver, and she plinks off a few shots and shoots a cop. So that's generally what happens. It's people defending their home, as they should have a right to do, including people that are selling chemicals and plants.
So your opinion is that if a judge signs a warrant and we raid your house, that during the process of that, when we know that you've sold dope to an undercover agent or whatever, that we're coming to arrest you, that it's okay for the drug dealers to shoot at the police, which compounds their problem, but that's okay to you?
Well, I would say that it would be reasonable to expect that to occur, that if somebody hears noises and sees things happening and, you know, they may grab their gun to protect their home. I'd say that it'd be reasonable to expect that to occur.
Wouldn't you be willing to defend your families?
But here's the difference, because I've got experience and you don't. So when the police come and they raid your house and we're shouting every single room that we go into, Sheriff's Department search warrant, Sheriff's Department search warrant, there are red and blue lights going out.
That doesn't make what you're doing okay.
And the rear of your house. It does make it okay.
No, it does not, sir. You are invading someone's home. You are invading a person's home. You're invading the sanctity of that person's life and their family. And many people who are innocent have died in your buddy's raid, sir.
Listen, we absolutely are invading your home. We absolutely are doing that, and we're doing that to protect your neighbors that despise you. We're doing that to protect everybody else in your community because they despise you. They despise
the life
that you live.
Ridiculous. Drug use is widespread in the United States, and many people, millions of Americans, use cannabis. Many of our neighbors are cannabis users. Some of them are probably the customers of the person whose home you're raiding, sir.
Very, very, very small percentage of drug raids that I've ever been involved with are for cannabis, okay? You know that, and I know that, but you're making a big deal about it. Move on to another point.
Well, what are you going to do to stop the war on drugs? There hasn't been the needle hasn't been moved as far as addiction goes in the United States. Drugs are consumed like they have been last decade, the decade before that, the decade before that. Police are failing year after year after year after year, continuing to collect more and more money. There's more and more cops, and they just continue to fail. What's your plan?
Okay. So a couple of years ago, our beloved Congress spends $3 million on an omnibus spending bill to research shrimp running on underwater treadmills. I would much rather prefer that money like that be spent on
your department,
going towards law enforcement.
But
you want more money.
But it has gone towards law enforcement.
Thanks for the honesty.
Nixon increased the money towards law enforcement and started the war on drugs. Reagan increased it. Clinton increased it. Bush increased it. You've got your increase.
God bless him. Okay.
He loves the money. That's what it's all about. You want bigger budgets. You're just another tax feeder, dude.
Here's one thing that you and I agree on. The problem is still there, okay? But don't expect me to or ask me to prove a negative. I can't prove a negative. But my argument to you would be, what happens if you pull that money away? You guys seem to think that if you legalize drugs, then all the crime that's involved with drugs, you or your partner there said it, that people are no longer going to break into people's
houses.
Yeah,
most of that's going to go away.
In Portugal, and that's what's happening in Amsterdam.
Hold your thoughts there, Tony. You know, maybe you don't understand economics. I mean, we can discuss that with you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. For someone who loves money so much, you should probably learn a little bit about it. It's Free Talk Live.
Attention. A very wealthy U.S. benefactor now reveals money-making secrets used by the rich and powerful. Credit success secrets once used only at the top levels of business are now being revealed to the general public. Imagine having a business that runs itself, puts money in your pocket so you never have to go to work. Imagine someone else gave you the money to start. Secret groups are pulling for your success by giving perfect scores in both business and personal credit. They show you how to get good credit and how to use good credit. If you have bad credit, no credit, or your credit isn't as good as that other guy's credit, it really doesn't matter anymore. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many get cash in pocket right now. Call now for free information on how Credit Success Secrets Revealed can put money in your pocket so you never work again. Call 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719 or go to creditsuccesssecretsrevealed.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new item on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveatpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at bitcoin.com. That's bitcoin.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Whatever you do, don't pull your steering wheel off its column. That's incredibly dangerous. And professionals like police officers should not be acting in such irrational, dangerous manners. Tony, who I believe was his name, the cop that was on the line, did unfortunately dropped off the line during during that moment there. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about the war on drugs and Ben Carson's desire to intensify it.
And he was concerned was crime. He was like suggesting that we were being Pollyannish about the legalization of drugs and what would happen in the absence of the war on drugs to crime rates. And what all I'm doing is looking at the evidence when, around the world, when they decriminalize drugs, what happens? When you look at Portugal, you look at Amsterdam, and you see these notions. You look at California, which has had marijuana legalized, and crime rates in the United States have dropped, and they've dropped in California, too. I'm not saying it's necessarily related to the legalization of marijuana, but you can also extrapolate, hey, look, their alcohol used to be illegal, and now it's not. There's not a lot of criminal gangs that are continuing to finance themselves through the sale of bathtub gin. Like, that has been taken over by business people, and it's being sold in the marketplace. I would dare to say that the people who were selling drugs illegally, marijuana illegally in Colorado, Washington, Oregon, California, Alaska, these places that have legalized it, Washington, D.C., that they have had to find different work. Now, maybe that work was other illegal drugs. Certainly, I'm not claiming that that's not the case, but I'd like to understand what kind of crime is going to be created by legalizing drugs. I'm talking about all of them. Yeah, I'm talking about meth and whatever these things are. I think that people would have better opportunities to seek help. I don't think that there's good use of meth. I just don't. Mm-hmm. I don't believe there's good heroin. Maybe you can, it may be cheaper.
I did know a housewife who used, I think it was meth. I think it was meth for a short period of time, and she seemed to have it under control. Like, it was something she used to help her clean around the house. But I wouldn't recommend it. It sounds incredibly dangerous.
That might be what she tells herself.
Well, she turned out okay. I mean, it wasn't an
The other thing you have to ask yourself is, why should you be taking my tax dollars when I don't agree to this program? I'm not in agreement.
I have a huge issue with going into people's homes, and this cop was just acting like it's no big deal. Hey, we've got this man in a robe signed a piece of paper that says we get to go in your house, and that's totally fine. Well, look, it's one thing if you're looking for an axe murderer, some sort of killer who's actually putting people in danger. That'd be one reason to raid a home, and I think I'd be all right with that.
You might see a couple hundred raids a year in the United States instead of 50,000.
It'd be one thing if the person inside the home was actually a danger to their neighbors. But I'm sorry, somebody who is buying and selling chemicals and plants on a consensual basis with other adults and other human beings who are consenting is not a danger to me. And it's absolutely the case that if you are to legalize drugs or just end prohibition of them to allow the marketplace to sell these things, you would see a dramatic decrease in crime. And that's what you do see in Portugal, for instance, where possession of small amounts of all drugs is essentially a legal thing to do. But you can do the research for yourself. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. We do have Kurt on the line in Pennsylvania. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Kurt.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Hey, what station are you listening to tonight?
Well, listening to 1160. I was coming back from Rhode Island. I don't know if your call screener said who I am, but Mark, this is Kurt Lowe, formerly of Sarasota.
Oh, hey. How's it going, Kurt?
An old buddy of yours, Mark? Yeah. How about that? It's a small world.
Mm-hmm. We worked together. Remember, was it WIBQ, Mark?
Yes.
All right.
The call letters have changed.
That's enough niceties. Let's get to the issues, Kurt. Go ahead.
Well, now, I live in Pennsylvania now, but I just moved here from Colorado, and I can tell you the best thing that happened in the state of Colorado is that the sale of alcohol went down and less people are out getting drunk and driving. So
really?
I think you guys, oh, absolutely. You guys are 100% spot on. It's funny, there would be a dispensary next door to a liquor store, and nobody would go into the liquor store, but the dispensary people would be packed.
No way. See, that I had not heard. I didn't realize that alcohol sales had suffered as a result of...
We knew that alcohol companies were against legalization of marijuana.
Sure.
And, you know... You'd figure they'd know their business.
I figured it would not really hurt it very much. I figured that people would just start doing both. But that's really interesting. I'm shocked and pleasantly surprised to hear that.
Now, I don't know if you guys are aware of it, but not every municipality and city and county actually legalized it. The state left it up to each municipality, city, and county as its own. The first place that I lived in western Colorado, was not legal. The entire county was dry, but yet... For a town of 60,000 people, they had 52 liquor stores.
Yeah.
But you know, I mean, I'm still on the radio, so I'm a public figure. So all I can tell you is that Colorado is a fantastic place to live if you want to go try.
Thank you, Kurt, for sharing that experience with us. I really appreciate hearing from you tonight.
Yeah, it's
drive safe out there. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, you know, if the phone lines are busy, we've got Skype. And nobody on hold on Skype right now. Skype username's lrn.fm. If you want to sound better than everyone else on the show except for the hosts, you can get on Skype. Skype username's lrn.fm. Let's go to Brock, listening in Guilford, New Hampshire, to WEZS. Hey, Brock.
Hey, how are you, dental people out there?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
You're doing a good show. You're doing a good show tonight.
Thanks.
And you're right back at it where you belong. I agree 100%. It's a shame we all just can't get everybody to understand, but I wanted to touch on something for people to think about and maybe use.
Yeah, do me one favor. Back off your phone by like a solid inch. It might make you sound a little bit better. You're distorting somewhat.
Okay. How's that?
Yeah, a little better. Go ahead.
It's Article 4, Section 2. It's one sentence in the U.S. Constitution, which is their rule book they have to behave by. And it says, citizens of each state shall be entitled to all privileges and immunities of citizens in the several states. Now, I see it as there's several states now that it's legal to do marijuana usage. And wouldn't the rest of the states have to go along, as opposed to if it was the other way around, regulations and things? I don't believe that would advance. This is opposite of all the regs. I mean, it basically says we have these privileges if there are several states that agree they are privileges and entitlements. And there are states out there that have you know, gotten more lenient about marijuana usage, enough so that there are several, which is more than two.
I agree with your assessment on this. I think it's also interesting that the United States government felt the need to pass an amendment to make alcohol illegal, but they just passed a law to make marijuana and other drugs illegal. I don't see, honestly, where the Constitution of the United States gives the United States federal government the power to make any drug illegal. That's not what's mentioned in the Constitution as one of their powers, and all the rest of the powers that aren't mentioned are supposed to be remanded back to the states.
Well, and beyond that, if you have a right to your own body, then you should have a right to put in your body whatever you want, not a privilege, which means you'd have to ask permission. Brock, thanks for your call and the thoughts. And you can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Whether you want to comment on Ben Carson's proposal to intensify the war on drugs or whatever happens to be on your mind, you can join us here for the live Saturday show. By the way, I do have more from Ben Carson. He's got more of his quote that I think is worth finishing up. We'll do that when we get the chance. It's Free Talk Live.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American-made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, and your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and it's the live Saturday edition of the program. You may join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know what? On this show, we're big fans of Bitcoin. It's an alternative currency, probably arguably the world's most popular alternative currency at this point. Gold and silver, they're great. No doubt about it. Great ways to invest and kind of hold your value over time. Bitcoin's a whole new animal, and it really makes transacting business around the world super easy. It's effective at what it does, which is decentralizes money. It takes it out of the hands of government, and it puts it into your hands. It takes it out of the hands of the banks as well. Of course, governments and banks aren't so happy about that, but there's really not much they can do to stop it. There's the Bitcoin Investor Conference coming up, the first one ever, and it's starting on Thursday. Mark, you're going to be there.
That's right. Thursday, October the 29th at the D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas. I'm excited to do our first ever remote broadcast from Las Vegas. So come out and see me Thursday and Friday at the D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas. You can get your tickets at bitcoininvestor.com. It's bitcoininvestor.com.
Yeah, you don't want to wait till the day of, I imagine, because prices usually go up. So get your tickets now.
Yeah, they're really low cost, $100 a ticket.
That's it? For a Vegas conference?
Yep.
I don't know how he did that. That's amazing.
I don't know.
The D Hotel takes Bitcoin.
Yes.
All right. So bitcoininvestor.com. Mark, you're going to be there Thursday and Friday for both days of the conference, broadcasting live on both evenings, correct?
That's correct.
All right, cool. So go check that out. And you can join us here toll free at 855-450-FREE. Let's go on with your calls and thoughts. And then more from Ben Carson, who says he wants to actually intensify the war on drugs because it hasn't failed hard enough. He wants it to fail harder, apparently, because that's all that's going to happen.
Bigger budgets, more failure.
Yeah, you're not going to solve the drug problem by throwing more money and more cops at the problem. Mike is listening in Indianapolis to WIBC FM. Hello, Mike.
Yeah, good evening. Hey, listen, I don't necessarily agree with you guys on the whole drug issue, but that's not what got my hair up. When you guys made the comment that if police kicked in your door to issue a warrant about protecting yourself and your property. Listen, if they're within their rights according to the Fourth Amendment to the Constitution, without regard to whether you think that selling plants and chemicals should be legal, that's a whole different issue. You have to get that part legal. But to say something as stupid as to saying you have the right to defend yourself when they're executing a legal warrant, you would probably get what you had deserved to have coming to you.
Well, you'll probably get killed.
I wasn't advocating that. I'd like to be clear. I don't believe that violence solves problems. But at the same time, if somebody's awoken from a dead sleep and they think their house is being raided and their children are being put in danger by a home invasion, it's not a surprise when they decide to shoot at the invaders.
Right. I don't think we said that it's a good idea to shoot at police. I think what we said was it is a reasonable expectation that this is going to happen.
And it should be your right to defend against invaders of your home. I don't care if they got a piece of paper.
Then what good's the Fourth Amendment or any other amendment?
Yeah, what about the Fourth Amendment? Your right to privacy? Your right to privacy should include not having men with guns come into your house.
And it also protects you from illegal search and seizure if it's been properly signed, if they've dotted all the T's and dotted all the I's, crossed all their T's. Then they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. And by the way, I've had my door kicked in the middle of the night. You know what's going on. They make it very clear to you. Okay,
you have one experience one time. I don't know what it's like for these people. There's 50,000 drug raids that go on in this country every single year. And look, the Constitution we have is resulted in the government we have. I don't know if I think the Fourth Amendment's a really great thing. However, it hasn't stopped the drug war, which has been the biggest erosion of the Fourth Amendment in U.S. history. The Fourth Amendment, if you like it, you should be against the drug war.
No, without regard to where my position on drugs are, whether you have to take, if you don't like that law, then you have to fight against that law. But until you do fight against that law, and as long as it is legal, have the right, according to the Constitution, to do what they have to do to serve that warrant.
When I was in prison, hold on just a second. I spent 9 years in prison, and I can tell you that I talked to a great deal of home invaders, bank robbers, and a variety of violent people that used guns. You know what their number one technique was to get compliance in these circumstances?
I'm listening.
They called themselves police. They'd say, "Police, get down!" They'd say, "Freeze!" You know, they'd say the kind of things that police would say.
Yeah, so how are you supposed to know? It's 4 in the morning.
When you advocate for blind obeisance to a piece of paper, you advocate for empowering criminals, for empowering people to break into people's homes and shoot them and slit their kids' throats. You're advocating for the same systems that these violent criminals use.
What are the number of invasions in that circumstance compared to the number of evasions that are legal?
I have no idea.
There's no way to know.
There's 50,000 drug raids in the United States. I don't have an answer to your question at my fingertips.
It's slim to none. My point is...
Wait. What is slim to none? What is slim? Are you saying there are fewer...
I would guarantee you that the number of home invasions done by yelling, "Police, freeze," on the ground, whatever, compared to the cops actually serving a... search warrant is slim
to
none.
So, just to clarify, you're saying the police commit more home invasions than criminals?
Legal home invasions.
It's the same difference, man. They're destroying someone's sanctity of their home.
The fact is if you're a drug dealer, you're more likely to have your home invaded by competing drug dealers who are going to commit crimes. So you don't ever get that
legal,
kind of statistic.
One's legal, one's
I don't care
not, right?
if it's
I understand
legal.
It's legal.
It was legal, sir, to turn in escaped slaves back in the time of the Civil War. Did that mean it was a good thing to do?
What you're comparing apples and oranges here?
No, sir. You were telling me no. You don't get to dodge this. You were telling me it's legal, and that's an excuse.
Hey, if it was legal at the time, then yes, they changed the law.
What would you have done? Would you have turned in an escaped slave?
You know what? I have no idea because that was how many years ago?
Well, let's put yourself. It's still you. You're still you. You have your same beliefs. Now warp yourself back 150 years. So if there was an escaped slave who asked you for help, hiding him from being found, would you help him or would you turn him in?
Yes, I would help him.
Good. So you'd break the law. You'd break the law.
Right.
Coming to me just like you would if you were to defend yourself when a legal search warrant was being shot.
By the way, I'm glad to hear that you would hide the slave. Yeah. That's good. I'm glad to hear that
you're,
you do
you're
the
a man
right
of conviction
thing.
Will stand up against a tyrannical government, and good for you.
Thanks, Mike, for your call tonight. I appreciate it. These cops that are coming into people's homes and acting like it's somehow justified because they have a piece of paper, that is so sick to me. It's so wrong.
I don't think the piece of paper justifies it, but...
Well, he was saying it's constitutional, and then there's a judge who signs this piece of paper, so it's okay.
Yeah, I mean, as far as I'm concerned, laws are written by, what we call down south liars, and, they're just paid liars writing stuff on pieces of paper. Politician is synonymous with a liar and a thief. That's meaningless to me. What's right and what's wrong is I can see why there might be an armed group of people that might bust into somebody's home if that person is a terrible criminal and needs to be brought to some kind of justice. And I hope the best for those people that bust into someone's home under those circumstances. Mm-hmm. I'm not hoping against those people. And my hope doesn't really make a difference in the face of bullets. What I'm saying here is that, I'm against the law, but, the law just does not delineate what is right and wrong.
Exactly. Let's go to Joe. He's in Indianapolis listening to WIVC-FM. Hey, Joe. Joe in Indy, going once. Joe in Indy, you're on the air. Go ahead, sir.
Okay, so let's get down to brass tacks here. I am in support of you guys in so many different aspects, but when you talk about getting advice from a woman who does crystal meth to clean her house... You kind of lose a little bit of credibility.
I didn't say I got advice from that woman. I was giving an example of somebody. Hang on, Joe. I was giving an example of somebody that I know personally who did not get addicted to crystal meth. I'm not advocating it. I think it's one of the most dangerous, deleterious drugs out there.
You made that clear.
If I wasn't clear about that, it's Free Talk Live. As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You may join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Skype username is lrn.fm. If you enjoy Free Talk Live, you like the message that we portray here on the radio waves in over 150 radio stations around the country, and also on satellite across Africa, much of Africa, North and Central America, on the internet, via podcast, via live streaming, you like us getting the message of liberty out there, and you want to help us do that, $5 a month is all it costs to become a Free Talk Live amplifier. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote. That's because the $5 a month that you send us is actually invested into Free Talk Live so we can be a more effective voice for liberty around the world. You get perks, too. You get access to the AMP-only Facebook group, the AMP-only phone lines, and more. Go and learn more and get signed up through our new website over at amp.freetalklive.com. And it's not quite time yet, but very soon we'll be announcing an exciting change to the Free Talk Live AMP program that will allow even more people to AMP the show than have ever been able to do it before. I'll say this. How would you like to be able to AMP without giving up any of your personal information? We're going to do that very soon. I'm hoping. I've got my fingers crossed that it's going to be very, very soon. So, but right now, you still can use credit cards, which, of course, do require your personal information, over at amp.freetalklive.com. You can use PayPal as well. That's amp.freetalklive.com. As we continue here, Sharon is on the line in St. George, Utah. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Sharon.
Hi, Shay. Concerning those two officers, I worked in the projects right there in Vegas, and I sort of know where they're coming from.
Which two officers? I'm sorry.
you just had two officers online there.
Okay, on people who were on hold with us here. Gotcha.
We had one guy. I don't know if
I think there was at least one guy, but yeah, go ahead.
All right. I have some ideas that we did in the projects there, which we had some really nice officers come in with real good intentions. They wanted to help the kids, and they set up a metro station and trying to help young people there. And they would do things like, because it was very serious, going into a crack house is very serious. It's not a joke. And they would do little things like, pretty soon they started realizing their life was in danger big time. So they would drive up at the side of anybody that was coming up to make a purchase, and they'd just yell out to them with their microphone, say, I saw you went to so-and-so's house. Well, the guy just take off, you know. Well, they do that enough, and what does it do? What's the amount of business?
I would think.
They would put sign. Yeah, well, it was a good attempt. It's better than walking into an Uzi or something, you know.
Yeah, okay.
But they would also do signs up that say, you're being videoed. And it really, really helped. One thing I will say, bigger part of those arrests were crack. And people from all walks of life would come into those projects and try and get the kids to even sell from them.
Sure.
There was one darling little girl there that narrow shoulders, narrow hips, perfect for a black ballet company that they'd formed. And the mother would never let me bring her over. Well, I found out what she was doing was sending her daughter to the door to sell the drugs. And if the daughter got picked up, she'd be put, you know, in detention for a few months. And
right.
Then
no criminal charges.
The mother, yeah, if the mother got caught, why, it would be heavy duty criminal charges, you know. So they were using their children, some of them. I think it, and as far as
these are consequences of the war on drugs, right? I mean, if these drugs were all legal, then you'd just have to go to Walgreens and then, you know,
you don't
no
see
kids
little girls selling beer.
Right.
I have mixed feelings on that. I would see some of the boys that I worked with. We started them out with small little backos, and pretty soon Raiders football player came in, who you might know there in Las Vegas, Frank Hawkins. He came in and started funding them, and we had big backos, and we were teaching the kids how to drive large backos. This didn't take federal
What's a backos?
Program.
Backhoe?
Backhoe?
Oh, have it. Thank you. Yes, okay. Thank you. It was great. These kids just loved it. You could tell so much about each individual boy when he got onto it.
There's no doubt that giving kids some things to do is certainly a good way to keep them away from drugs. There's no doubt about that. But the war on drugs, of course, hasn't kept drugs out of the hands of young people.
It's the boys that were on marijuana were harder to motivate. They got sluggish on us. It get silly, wouldn't listen to you seriously. So that would be my my argument if I was going to have any.
Right. Can you imagine how much worse life would be if they ended up getting put in a cage because they liked marijuana? Boy, that would really ruin things for them, wouldn't it?
That's not my argument. I'm telling you what it does to them, which it's
I understand what you're saying, but they were doing that when it was illegal, right, Sharon? Those boys that were on marijuana were illegally using marijuana.
Yes.
Right, so that means that they were risking going into a cage because of that. Now, do you think that going to a cage would make their lives better?
I don't think they even realize the full consequences.
Well, they might find them out the hard way.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right about that.
Thanks, Sharon, for the call tonight. That's certainly true. I mean, young people don't necessarily know how serious the government can be about some of these things.
Yeah, many times they've got a life sentence before they ever get a chance to figure it out, too.
Yeah, and it doesn't make life better. I mean, there's all kinds of politicians who have admitted to using cannabis in their past. In fact, the last few presidents of the United States have all admitted it. Do you think they would have made it to president had they ended up going ahead and spending a few years in jail because of their habits?
I doubt that's the case. I'm not thrilled with the idea of all of America's youth just being stoned all the time. That's not what my argument wouldn't be that. I'm not advocating for that. However, I'm reasonably certain that young people and people generally are going to want to alter their states. There's a huge alcohol industry in this in the country. Marijuana's coming up in many states. We'll be able to see what the results are in those cases. And I think many times the drug warriors still won't change their minds. I can show you what happened in Amsterdam, and I can show you what happened in Portugal. Mm-hmm. But if you make your money and your livelihood off of the war on drugs, you're never going to be convinced by what I say because your mortgage depends on it.
Let's go to Scott. He's in Charleston, South Carolina, listening to our newest affiliate, WTMA, at least officially. Hey, Scott.
Hey, good evening, gentlemen. Welcome. I'm a fan of the show for about 7 or 8 years.
Thanks.
On weekends. Listen, I love you guys, and I'm in favor of legalizing drugs, and I hope you'll let me spell out my plan. But I got two bones to pick, and
we love picking bones on this show. Go ahead.
Okay, Ian, I've been in and out of the car. I heard you. I got in the car, and you were talking to a guy named Tony, and saying you don't know anything about economics.
Yeah, he was drug war supporting cop.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't hear all that, but, you know, he may not know anything about economics, and that's fine, and I've watched over the years. Ian, you're best when you're educating. Mark, I am a far right-wing conservative who's been persuaded that, you know, we should legalize drugs. But just something you said, you know, an hour ago maybe. You know, you don't want these, you know, people itching for a fix breaking in your home while you're sleeping. Did you say something to that effect?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah,
sure.
No one wants that.
Okay. Now, to me, that's a challenge. I mean, to me, look, I want to legalize drugs, but I'm not going to do it out of fear. I want to do it out of reason, out of logic. But, you know, that just put the hair on my back up.
Well, me too. Well, I want to do it for reason and logic too. But what people need to understand is that when they advocate for the war on drugs, they advocate for innocents on the sideline being harmed. It's not my house or your house I'm talking about. I'm talking about the other people's houses who are not prepared for somebody breaking into their home and to do harm to be able to get some cheap stuff to sell at a pawn shop to be able to get their next fix. I don't want to put those people in that circumstance.
I agree. I just don't want to. Maybe I'm one person. Maybe it's my one personality. I don't want to, you know, make this leap out of fear because, you know, if we're doing it because of that, I'm like, oh, maybe we need to double the drug budget. You know,
they've tried that.
They've doubled it, more than doubled it.
Yeah. Hey, Scott, I see where you're coming from. I agree that, you know, fear shouldn't be the motivator for ending the war on drugs. There's plenty of logic.
Can
there's
I
plenty
give
of
you my idea.
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sirs?
Fast though. Fast. Real fast.
And okay. Look, you know, I don't think government I don't think one tax dollar should be spent on taking people off of drugs. When you're at the stoplight and your 5-year-old and your 6-year-old's in the back seat and they say, Daddy or Mommy, why is that man sleeping on the sidewalk? You just say, oh, he did drugs.
Yeah, he probably did alcohol. Thanks for the call tonight, Scott. I appreciate it.
He probably did plenty of different types of drugs.
855-450-3733. And you can join us here. This is the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. The new 4th edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism, will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the 4th edition of Healing Our World is a great gift for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, October 24th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.84 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,164 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $282. Antiwar.com reports at least 22 civilians were killed on Friday and another 40 wounded after a suicide bombing against a Shiite religious process in the Pakistani city of Jacobabad. Five of the slain were children, and so far no group has claimed credit for the blast. The procession was commemorating the ninth day of Muharram, a part of the holiday Ashura, which is hugely important for Shiite Muslims. It is also commonly attacked by Sunni Islamist groups across the Middle East, particularly in Iraq, where massive pilgrimages are held. The processions in Pakistan, however, aren't nearly so big, but with ongoing sectarian violence in Pakistan, these smaller processions are still a popular target, despite efforts to make a major show of security by the Pakistani government. Such efforts to secure Shiite targets are common in Pakistan, but usually not very successful, as the various factions seem to find a way to hit these targets, with suicide attackers showing surprising effectiveness at infiltrating such gatherings and causing major casualties.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the Department of Justice on Friday said no charges are warranted against the Internal Revenue Service following a two-year investigation into claims that the government's tax-collecting arm illegally targeted right-wing conservative groups seeking tax-exempt status. DOJ officials opened the probe in 2013 amid claims that the IRS was setting its sights on applications from conservative groups. The allegations said the agency singled out their applications for extra scrutiny, while liberal groups met no such obstacle. On Friday, the DOJ announced it had closed the investigation after finding no evidence of illegal activity by the IRS, its employees, or former official Lois Lerner. Assistant Attorney General for Legislative Affairs Peter Kudzik wrote in an eight-page letter on Friday, "Our investigation uncovered substantial evidence of mismanagement, poor judgment, and institutional inertia, leading to the belief by many tax-exempt applicants that the IRS targeted them based on their political viewpoints, but poor management is not a crime. We found no evidence that any IRS official acted on political, discriminatory, corrupt, or other inappropriate motives that would support a criminal prosecution." Kudzik also said the investigation, conducted by the DOJ's Criminal and Civil Rights Division, the FBI, and the Treasury Department's Inspector General for Tax Administration, found no evidence that any IRS official attempted to obstruct justice after the fact either. Lerner, who was held in contempt of Congress last year for refusing to answer the allegations, was placed on administrative leave during the investigation and ultimately resigned in September 2013. She was the head of the IRS's department responsible for processing tax-exempt applications. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans Program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans Program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans Program, visit fans.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a proposed Alaska bridge that became a symbol of wasteful federal spending on politicians' pet projects has officially been scrapped a decade after the idea was first floated, according to state officials. Dubbed the Bridge to Nowhere, it would have connected the small city of Ketchikan to its airport on nearby Gravina Island, and it secured a $223 million earmark in 2005. Earmarks of nearly $450 million to help finance two proposed bridges produced cries of outrage from opponents who saw them as exemplifying federal waste. Alaska got the money in the end, but the earmarks were lifted. Jeremy Woodrow, Alaska Department of Transportation spokesman, said state officials had studied less expensive bridge options, but opted to pursue upgrading the ferry facilities for those making the 15-minute water commute. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Mere days before his upcoming relocation to Denver, Colorado, four-year Chicago resident Paul Marsden admitted today that he wished he had taken a little more time to truly loathe the city he has lived in for nearly half a decade.
You know, I've been here for a couple years, but now that I'm finally leaving, I realize I never really got to hate this place.
Marsden confirmed that in the time he's lived in the city, he never quite managed to explore his own shitty neighborhood, adding that he regrets never getting to know the stuck-up workers at the cafe down the block, never visiting the overpriced bodega on his corner, and never becoming violently ill from the food at the crappy Mexican place across the street from him.
You know, I lived right next to that bar for 4 years, and I just wish I took more time to abhor the disgusting smell that hits you every time you walk by. I'd always heard this place blows. Guess it's a shame I never got to hate it like I should.
For more on this story, check this week's Onion Review.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
That's right, it is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition. You may join us here if you want. You don't have to talk about war on drugs. That has been the issue on the table tonight. As prefaced by Ben Carson, one of the Republican presidential candidates, who is saying that he believes the war on drugs should be intensified, which, of course, is just absolute insanity. I mean, anybody that's looked at the war on drugs over the years knows that it has absolutely been intensified, and you do not get better results with an intensified war on drugs. You get bigger police budgets. The police get more toys like Bearcats and things like that, guns.
You get stronger organized crime syndicates, too.
Yep. You also get more of our friends and family members and coworkers and neighbors put in jail cells. They love filling up the jails with those drug users.
You get a more powerful and unaccountable government as the Bill of Rights is eroded.
Yeah, you do get all of those things. And if you want to comment on the idea of intensifying the war on drugs, you can do that. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 as we continue with your calls and thoughts. Also, we've got Skype. You may Skype into the show. It's Skype username lrn.fm. Straight Razor is on the line from Texas. Straight Razor, you're a former cop. Go ahead with your thoughts.
So I have a few questions for the gentleman I heard speaking before about, well, if it's legal, they should do it and you should just fight to change the law. Well, here's the thing. Here's my question for him. If it being legal makes it right, how would he feel if I pulled him over, suspected there were drugs in his car, and asked him for a search, and he consented, and then proceeded to pull the interiors of his doors out, slice his seats, and pull the carpets out? Because when you consent to a search of your vehicle, you are actually consenting to the whole vehicle. In other words, I can dismantle pieces from your vehicle if I suspect there are drugs there. Would he feel that it was right for me to do that, even though he wasn't carrying drugs, just because the law says I can?
Wouldn't you be able to smell marijuana and then get the search warrant?
Well, we're going from if he consents, then I have, you know, full rights right then. Yeah. I can do whatever.
I understand, whatever, but he may say to himself, you know, I'm an adult and I'm smart enough not to consent. And these are the ways for people to dismiss it, dismiss these things. And I'm just saying that the power does lie within law enforcement to, you know,
he could he could lie and say he smells marijuana.
Yeah, who knows what anybody smells at any given time? I'm not going to go so far as to call it a lie.
I think Straight Razor's point, though,
the court's going to believe him.
I think Straight Razor's point, though, was that someone who agrees with the war on drugs would be likely to give consent. They would not be likely to say, I know my rights, I won't consent. You know, somebody who agrees with the war on drugs would likely go along with the cop's suggestion, right?
Well, exactly. And then, of course, when it comes to them, and you've now, you know, destroyed their property, all of a sudden it's a big deal. But when it's happening to someone else, it doesn't matter.
Right, then it's just enforcing the law. But when it's happening to you, then it's you know, an egregious violation of your rights.
Exactly. They would have a much different attitude. Now, as far as the warrants conversation, you know, no knock versus what, you know, whatever you want to say, I have always been against no knock warrants. There are very, very few situations where I would be for a no-knock warrant. No-knock warrant should be reserved for things like, hey, they've got 15 kids in their basement and they're torturing them. Mm-hmm. That would be something that I would suggest a no-knock warrant for. If you're just going after drug dealers, why am I going to charge their castle? Because that's what their home is. That's where they live. They know where their weapons are. They most likely have a plan for what they're going to do and how they're going to do it. So why am I going to take myself and put myself in their environment where they're going to have the most control? Why would I not wait for them?
Because you would be you seem rational, Straight Razor, but the reason why some cops would do that is because they're adrenaline junkies.
Well, That's probably part of it. Part of it is, well, what I say goes. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just absolutely insane to say, well, I can wait for them to come out of their, you know, their castle.
They're going to come out eventually.
Exactly. You know, you have to go shopping at some point. Now, as Amazon progresses, that may change. But for now, you still have to go down to the market to get, you know, some essential food items.
If you're stealing drugs, you've got things you've got to do.
Yep. Somebody's got to go get the baggies.
There aren't very many people who have some kind that are, you know, involved in some kind of productive activity, and by that I mean, you know, making money, that aren't leaving their house.
Yeah, and at some point he's probably going to go somewhere to restock, unless he's buying everything online, and again, that's probably not too prolific within the drug dealer community.
Plus, if you're reaping the benefits of the environment that's been created by the laws, then you're probably going to want to spend some of the money that you're making anyway on toys and everything else that goes along with that.
It seems like they have a reasonable amount of luck busting into the homes of drug dealers early in the morning. You know, they've got a system, and generally they're fine. There's the odd case where a police officer gets killed in that circumstance, but generally they manage to pull it off.
What you need to look at, though, is the information that they were tipped off. So if you're talking about a low-level dealer, you know, they may, you know, when I say low-level dealer, they may still be supplying, you know, 50 people. But, you know, they're not going to be near as hardened as, say, you know, an actual cartel member or something like that, where you're going to have legitimate problems. So they're going to choose the no-knock warrant on those cases based on the fact that they know that those aren't necessarily hardened targets. So they're going to be able to get in and do what they want to do relatively safely.
That's true.
Of course, they did have the case in Florida where they tried to go through a window, which I don't suggest, and a gentleman shot two police officers. And, you know, that's completely justified. Why would I not shoot someone coming through my window at 3 a.m.? So, you know, it's unintelligent to do this. You harm more people. And if you're really talking about not changing the drug laws because you want to, you say there's going to be more junkies. Well, if you're going to take that line and you're for federal spending, why would you not reallocate all of the money pumped into the war on drugs and pump it into a system of recovery?
Well, you heard I don't know if you were tuned in when Tony called earlier, who was a cop. He was basically gloating about the idea of having bigger budgets. So he doesn't want anything to go to a treatment program. He wants the budget for the police department.
Exactly.
Thanks, Straight Razor, for your call, man. Always appreciate the expertise from behind the lines as a former cop. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. That guy gets it.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, it just shows that, you know, everybody in every circumstance can look at these things differently.
Right.
This isn't
Even
Free
cops.
Talk Live against the cops.
Right. We're for the cops who are for the end of prohibition, and there are cops like that. There's law enforcement against prohibition. They're always worth a mention here. Leap.cc is their website, L-E-A-P, as in law enforcement against prohibition. These are cops and former cops and jail wardens and former state police and cops from all over the world who have signed on with law enforcement against prohibition because they know the truth. And sometimes they learned it the hard way. You know, they learned it from being the undercover operative. They learned it from being on the drug task force. They learned it from enforcing, from ordering other officers to enforce these laws. And they learned that it was counterproductive. They learned that if they actually do care about people, which is the ostensible purpose behind the war on drugs, if you break it down, the idea being that, you know, altering one's state of consciousness is somehow a bad thing, and so they want to stop people from doing that. If you do care about people, then the war on drugs is the worst way to express that because it is an uncaring system. The system is very inhumane. It's putting peaceful people who have never hurt another human being behind bars and forcing all of us to pay for it, which there's just so much to object to about that. I can't even begin. Let's go to Doug listening in Indianapolis because I want to get your calls and thoughts on here. Doug, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, hi. I would tell Tony, you know what? You know what you call that? You call that a cartel. When you're more worried about making money than actually doing good, which they're not doing, they're more worried about revenue. You call that a cartel, okay? My issue, are you going to go to break?
Well, we're going to bring you back for more, Doug. Stand by. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
In the business, we call that a telegraph.
Yeah. You can join
855-450-3733 Free Talk Live.
Also Skype in at Skype username lrn.fm. This is Free Talk Live's live Saturday show.
Attention. A very wealthy U.S. benefactor now reveals money-making secrets used by the rich and powerful. Credit success secrets once used only at the top levels of business are now being revealed to the general public. Imagine having a business that runs itself, puts money in your pocket so you never have to go to work. Imagine someone else gave you the money to start. Secret groups are pulling for your success by giving perfect scores in both business and personal credit. They show you how to get good credit and how to use good credit. If you have bad credit, no credit, or your credit isn't as good as that other guy's credit, it really doesn't matter anymore. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many get cash in pocket right now. Call now for free information on how Credit Success Secrets Revealed can put money in your pocket so you never work again. Call 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719, 1-800-707-8719, or go to creditsuccesssecretsrevealed.com.
Are you still looking for that one iodine that you can really trust? A medical doctor-endorsed product that is backed by honest research and true integrative science? Then search no further. Go to NutraMedical.com for Dr. Bill Deagle's Nutriodine, proven time and time again to be the very best iodine available for you. Nutriodine is the only Tesla-activated monatomic plasma iodine in the world. It optimizes mitochondrial function and generation of new mitochondria, from totally neutralizing the venom from a desert recluse spider bite in Southern California to eliminating malaria parasites reported by medical missionaries in Central India. Dr. Bill's Nutriodine is simply the most powerful healing formula there is. Nutriodine clears the body of all known pathogens, restores it to an alkaline state, and even promotes stem cell regeneration. Order Dr. Bill's Nutriodine today at 888-212-8871 or visit us online at NutriMedical.com.
A Japanese-American internment facility was still in operation in the mountains of Northern California. The facility should have been closed in 1945 and its 6,000 residents released, but unfortunately the camp was overlooked until this week. I am happy to announce, however, that the remaining 118 detainees have now been fully exonerated of suspicion of spying for General Tojo, and they have been freed. Next item of business. The president will be meeting with the Australian Prime Minister, Kevin Rudd. Yes, Denise?
This is a huge oversight. How could this have happened?
Well, Denise, it looks like the camp just somehow slipped through the cracks. The end of the Second World War was a hectic time in America, and it's only natural that we let a couple of things slip in our excitement over defeating the Nazis.
Who was going to be held responsible for this?
No, there won't. In fact, the War Relocation Authority was responsible for the decommissioning of the internment facilities, but that organization ceased to exist in 1946, so no.
This is the Onion News Network.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Friday, gold is down $1 at $1,168 per ounce, and silver is up 5 cents at $15.91 per ounce. Bitcoin is currently trading at $275. Halloween is almost upon us. Give your special ghosts and goblins a treat they won't soon forget, an Australian 1-ounce silver spider. To order yours today, give us a call at 800-874-9760 or online at rrbi.co.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Yeah! Oh yeah, it's Free Talk Live, and you can join us right here toll-free. The number is 855-450-FREE. Lots of talk about a favorite subject of mine. Not because I like the subject, but just because I'm well-educated about it. The war on drugs. This insane thing that has been going on in the United States and elsewhere around the world for my entire lifetime. I'm in my mid-30s at this point, and I've seen people that I know. I've seen them arrested for drug possession and drug sales, and I've seen that not a single one of them has been dissuaded from doing drugs after the fact. By the way, because the idea is that if you put them in jail, that'll cause them to stop using drugs. Well, as you pointed out, Mark, they can get the drugs on the inside of jail and inside prisons. And further, when they get out, I've known people who basically counted the days until they were off probation so they could get high again.
Having spent some time in prison myself and talked to at least a handful of my ex-friends I didn't spend a lot of time running around trying to find ex-convicts when mm-hmm. I was out of prison. I was glad to be rid of them. Frankly, my least favorite people in the world are convicts. But, I got to say that I can't think of one of them that hasn't in some way or another used drugs after getting out of prison. Yeah. There you go. But I knew a lot of people who never went to prison who used drugs, too.
Also, let's go back to Doug. He was in Indianapolis and still is in Indianapolis. You're on Free Talk Live again. Go ahead, Doug. You've got plenty of time for your thoughts.
I'm in Illinois, commonly called the North Korea of America.
Are you listening to WIBC from Illinois on the radio?
No, I actually have you on the TuneIn app.
Ah, excellent. All right, go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah, I mean, I've called in before, and to reiterate, the issue here can be all the way from a local cop all the way up to the attorney general and government can be when you have authority added to no accountability, you have it equal tyranny, which can be what we've got. I mean, when you do a no-knock raid and you get the wrong home, which they're doing more and more often, mm-hmm. and you have nobody held accountable, I mean, that should be the type of thing where the DOJ should be getting involved. And people should be locked up. You know what I mean?
Yeah, the people who are victims of these no-knock raids, who that wasn't the right house, they're lucky if the cops will even replace their front door.
Oh, not only that, they're lucky if they're walking away with their life.
That's true as well.
I mean, they commonly shoot the dog. They commonly shoot the property owner. You know, do property damage like you were bringing up. I mean, I can't tell you. Look at the one that happened in Florida where it actually had been a legitimate raid. Under the law, but it had been a flash grenade that got thrown in the crib and the little boy
was in Georgia
getting burned. That happened in Georgia?
Yes, sir.
Didn't it happen more than once?
Okay, well, there have been children killed,
Florida,
but
I believe, too. Yeah.
There was also another one recently where a little girl got shot. I don't know if it was a drug raid, but the cops were shooting at a dog and they shot like a 4-year-old girl
trying to shoot her dog. Shot her.
they're out of control. They are out of control. They have no accountability. And, you know, if their reply can be, well, then we're going to be afraid to do a raid, well, then you know what? You better make damn sure that you get the proper home. And if you're not going to get the proper home, you're going to be held accountable for it. You're going to be doing life in jail if you kill an individual, the property owner, and you got the wrong home. That should be what should happen.
Boy, that'd be amazing.
Yeah, that should be the proper thing that should happen. You don't have to have an intent when you're dealing with that type of thing.
I don't know why people are horrified at the idea of somebody going to prison who, you know, ends the life early of an individual who, you know, was completely innocent.
I also think that if somebody defends themselves in that circumstance, let's say they get the wrong house, like you had in multiple circumstances, the most memorable one is the 92-year-old lady in Atlanta, Georgia, who defended herself. If somebody defends themselves from a cop coming into the wrong house and they shoot and that cop dies, that person should be innocent.
Correct. And, you know, that should be the type of thing where the DOJ should be getting involved in it. Loretta Lynch or Eric Holder. I mean, we have a pattern here of them not doing what they should do. What are they currently working on now? Well, the DOJ, I don't know if you heard, they're going after Apple right now. They want to be able to get into the back door of the Apple operating program.
Yeah, I did hear about that.
They're going to be taking them to court. You have, you know, in Rome they wondered who will watch the people doing the watching.
Who will watch the watchers?
Here can be what we've got. Right. Here can be what we've got. We've got a problem with accountability. The people with a higher degree of authority have to have a higher degree of accountability.
But how do we get from here to there, though? I mean, I agree with your assessment completely. How do we get there?
I don't know. I have no idea.
I've got an idea.
Maybe it should be another elected official put in that will...
That'll never work.
You know what? We need more politicians and bureaucrats.
Yeah, the politicians are part of the problem.
The only thing that I can think of me being a libertarian could be to limit the authority of the government and shrink it. That should be what should happen.
Right. Now, how do you... So that's the ultimate challenge, is how do you get the libertarian agenda implemented? The answer is the Free State Project. So for anybody that is a libertarian, liberty-minded person, a voluntarist, if you love freedom, then you really owe it to yourself to look at the Free State Project. It's the idea of concentrating activism of libertarians in one place, in one geographic area. New Hampshire was the chosen destination. It was chosen by a vote of the first 5,000 members of the Free State Project, or participants in the Free State Project, back in 2003. And the moves have been, the people have been moving ever since then. We've had actually over 1,500 people make the move here already as part of the Free State Project. And get this, they're getting elected. Libertarians around the rest of the country don't get elected, but here they can run as Republicans and Democrats, and they've been getting elected. We've had dozens of electoral successes, and the Free State Project hasn't even officially begun the move yet. We're early movers, Mark and I, and the other 1,500-plus. If somebody moves tomorrow, they're an early mover. We just had a new couple move here from San Francisco. They've been blown away. We had like 20 people come out to meet them and welcome them to New Hampshire when they arrived here in Keene. And they're not even intending to stay in Keene. They were just here, you know, visiting, and they're going to go to some other places in the rest of the state. And they'll probably meet another 150 people when they do that. It was an amazing experience for them to be around that many people, because even though they came from San Francisco, which is a huge city, there were maybe, you know, 5 libertarians that were active in San Francisco. So if we can concentrate our efforts, maybe we can create that more libertarian society. Maybe we can create a system in which the police are actually held to account for their actions. There's a lot of work to be done, but I'd recommend checking it out. Doug, thanks for your call and the thoughts tonight. Definitely on board with what you had to say. And again, freestateproject.org. It's over 17,000 participants right now. When you go to freestateproject.org, they have a little ticker that shows you how many signers they have, how many people have actually moved here to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. I mean, Mark, it's been a great experience so far, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's home for me. I think that we've had a lot of success, and I've learned a lot since we've moved here.
I love it when more people show up, too, because it means that, you know, we're getting fresh blood, we're getting new ideas, new people with, you know, new talents to lend to the movement. Over 17,500 people now on board with the Free State Project. It's going up about 100 per month, so we're probably on target to reach the goal of 20,000 participants in about 2 years from now. And of course, it could speed up even more toward the end. I'm hoping it does. I'm hoping people get really excited in like the last 1,000 or so. And then we just
zips along.
Yeah, we just see it shoot up to 20,000. Then that triggers the official move to New Hampshire. There's a 5-year window when everyone who's signed has to move here and then to get active in whatever way you think is best. And we are seeing that this works. If you want to see more evidence that it works, go to 101reasonsfilm.com. There's 101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire. It's a great little hour-long documentary. You can watch the whole thing online for free. 101reasonsfilm.com. If you love liberty, you owe it to yourself to spend an hour on this. It'll blow you away, I think. This is Free Talk Live. Join us here on the radio. Your calls coming up.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday show continuing. Of course, you can join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Skype on in here to the show at Skype username lrn.fm. There's been a lot of discussion so far tonight regarding the war on drugs. And what sparked all of it was Ben Carson, who he really doesn't get it. He thinks that he can have success in the war on drugs by intensifying the war on drugs. And, you know, the guy's a neurosurgeon, so supposedly, you know, you probably got to be kind of smart to be a neurosurgeon. How you could be so intelligent and be a neurosurgeon but yet be so clueless on this particular topic, I guess it's possible because that's what he's doing. But look, the war on drugs doesn't work when you use force, when you use aggressive force against people. It works out in unintended ways. The consequences sometimes are predictable, but they're unintended. You know, you want to stop drugs, so you start putting people in jail cells. Well, guess what? If the person's been in a jail cell, they probably have lost their job because, you know, they've been charged with something, or they missed work because they were arrested and they couldn't go to work because they were in the jail cell. So then you let them out, because ultimately they'll all be let out at some point, unless you're advocating the death penalty for drugs, which is really crazy. Then they get out and they've got no job, and they might have lost their home as well, unless they happen to have a partner who was able to stay in the house and somehow make the rent payments without them bringing in the
second
money.
Income or yeah. primary income for that
yeah.
matter.
And then so you've given that person more of a reason to get addicted to drugs. You know, if they weren't a drug addict before, because remember, not everyone who gets arrested for drug use is an addict. Many of them are just recreational users who, just like recreational alcohol users, have their habit under control. It doesn't rule their life, but they're, whether they're an addict or not doesn't matter to the police who stop them on the, you know, the road or whatever and bust them for having a plant in their pocket. That's all that matters, is whether they have the plant or whether they have the chemical or not. So you let them out of jail, now they don't have a job, now they might not have a place to stay. What's that going to lead to? Is that going to lead to a better life for that person? I don't think so. And that's just one of a myriad of stories. I mean, everybody's got their own individual spin on this particular story, how the war on drugs has affected their life in a negative way. And I'm sure you can find people out there who will say, well, if I hadn't have been arrested, then I never would have solved my drug problem, right? Like, they hit rock bottom. The old right. story of you hit rock bottom and then you go to jail.
Could that person have found rock bottom another way?
Yes.
And could that other way, is there another way to provide change for people that isn't the war on drugs? Because the war on drugs at this point, I don't think anybody can call it a success at what it's supposed to do. I mean, you can call it a success at, you know, supporting larger police budgets and, you know, making organized crime organizations more powerful and doing a variety of things, but you can't claim it stops people from, you know, the percentage of people from doing drugs.
The way you handle things differently without jail is through compassion for other human beings who have a problem and allowing those people who have a problem to seek help for that problem. When drugs are illegal, it's a scary thing. People don't want to seek help, even if they want to end their heroin addiction or whatever, because they're afraid they're going to get turned in. They're afraid that the doctors are going to call the police on them. They're afraid that it's going to get out that they're a drug addict and that's going to make their life worse, or that they'll get arrested by the police. And what you see happening in Portugal, that has had legal drugs, you can possess drugs of all sorts legally in personal amounts. They've had this now for well over a decade at this point. And the addictions, the drug addicts, the number of them has gone down by 40% the last time I looked at the statistics, which was a couple years ago. And that's because people aren't afraid to get the help that they need. There's not a prohibition on them personally. Yes, they have a problem. They can seek the assistance. And if the money isn't being poured into the insane war on drugs, then maybe it can actually go to help people beat their issues. And of course, legalizing drugs also means that you take it out of the black marketplace, which disempowers drug cartels and puts business and puts money in the hands of American businesses, the people who would then be the people who sell the marijuana, for instance, as we're seeing happen in Colorado. And of course, in Colorado and Washington and the other states where it's legal, the state is actually getting in millions upon millions of dollars in revenue that they never had gotten before. So there's that as well, which I'm not a huge fan of that, but that's probably what you're going to need to use to convince the politicians. Wayne, you're in Indianapolis listening to WIBC.
Yes.
You're on the radio. Go
How
ahead.
Are you?
Oh, excellent. Go ahead, sir.
Oh, great. Well, I've got a couple of issues here.
All right.
First of all, the police activity when you break into a person's house. There was the Tony Corinthians incident a number of years ago, and I believe some police were trying to break into his house, and he shot him. And I don't know, but he's probably still in jail.
Was it the wrong house? I'm not familiar with that particular incident.
No, I believe it was the right house. I don't know. I don't know what it was. The policeman was trying to break, to enter his house, and he pulled a gun and shot him. And it was a big issue here in Indianapolis, what, 30 years ago or so, maybe?
Okay, yeah, that's definitely before the time that that I've been paying attention to it. But, you know,
no one's going to have any sympathy for somebody who's, say, dealing drugs or something like that. The police are executing
this. He wasn't dealing drugs.
Okay. He wasn't?
He wasn't dealing drugs. Okay. No.
So why were the police coming into his house? Do you recall that?
No, I don't.
All right. Well, thanks, but, Wayne, for your. What was the second issue? Well, go real fast with your second thing.
Well, the second issue is that I haven't smoked any weed in about 30 years or so, but I've noticed that it is for sale everywhere. I mean, not necessarily cannabis to smoke. The smoke cannabis is frowned upon, but they'll sell you hemp granola at the Whole Foods.
Not the same thing. So hemp granola is not, that's not going to get you high.
Made from hemp, isn't it?
But right. Hemp's illegal, yeah.
Hemp's illegal to grow.
You correctly state that.
But you can have hemp-based products in the United States. That's legal to do.
Right.
Hemp will not get you high. The difference is hemp is the male
well, I know
plant.
That it won't get you. Yeah.
So it's not
but
the same thing.
I mean, what I'm saying is you have this vegetable, which is seemingly healthy as hell, and the only thing you can't do with it is smoke it.
Oh, you also can't do a lot of things with the female version of the plant. Thank you for the call, Wayne. I appreciate it. With marijuana or cannabis, scientific term, with cannabis, there's a male plant, there's a female plant. The female plant is the one that has flowers on it. The flowers, the buds, are the marijuana product, the cannabis that is sold by the black marketplace. That is what is being bought and sold in the legal markets. Hemp is the name typically given to the male version of the plant, which does not flower. It's just this stalky plant that the product is very, very useful for a lot of different things, whether it's making products to eat.
Rope.
Or clothing. Rope. Or yeah. Building materials. Or there's all kinds of things that you can do with hemp.
You can smoke it. You can eat it. You can build with it.
Unfortunately, in almost every state, it is illegal to grow hemp, just as it is illegal to grow the flowering plant. And so, and they look similar, right? You know,
sure.
At a distance. So that needs to end too. The prohibition on hemp needs to go away. People should be able to grow hemp. People should be able to grow cannabis, and they should be able to use it for whatever purposes they feel fit. Bill, listening in central Indiana to WIBC. Hello, Bill. Bill in central Indiana.
Good evening.
Hi.
Good evening, gentlemen. How are you?
Welcome, sir. Great. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, I'm a retired guy, and I spent 35 years of my life as a high-ranking federal agent with the Treasury Department fighting the war on drugs. I was there the day it began.
Wow.
And it wasn't over the day I left. So
it's a long-fought war.
Let me tell you how things begin in the United States. Is somebody has a reasonably good idea for the common good of the population. The politicians say, well, we've got to get rid of this. I don't care what we're talking about. Everything from drugs to these no smoking bans in entire cities. You know, they always want to take care of the masses.
Bill, I want to hear your perspective, having been through a lot of this. Stand by. I want to bring you back for that. It's Bill in Central Indiana. Your calls and thoughts are also welcome at 855-450-FREE. You've got Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years.
and satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access on or off when you want for free at webcurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. Webcurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with a click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit webcurfew.com.
Hunter. Anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow. A new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Lockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. LockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at LockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. LockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
This is novelist Tom Robbins. When my mother was diagnosed with glaucoma, her conservative Virginia physician told her there was only one treatment that might ease her pain and save her eyesight. That treatment was medical marijuana, which he could not prescribe. I offered to get her some and teach her how to use it effectively, but my father objected because marijuana was against the law. So my mother, who loved to read and walk in nature, was condemned to grow cruelly, unnecessarily blind. Tragedies like this happen all the time, but they don't have to keep happening. To learn more about medical marijuana, call the Marijuana Policy Project at 1-877-JOIN-MPP or visit them on the web at mpp.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Maybe we've got enough time for you tonight, but if not tonight, don't worry. We do the show live 7 nights a week. You can always get on the radio with us and talk about whatever you happen to have on your mind. Now, of course, drugs have been the topic tonight. Ben Carson is apparently in favor of an increased, an intensified is his word, intensified war on drugs. And I'm sure the police around the country are very, very happy about that because, well, a lot of the police, not all of them. Some of them are... they're sensible. They've seen that the war on drugs is a failure and that it's not helping the people that they're supposedly there to serve. If you're there to serve and protect me, I would prefer you stop arresting my friends and family members and neighbors for having a plant or a chemical on them. That would be service to me. And in fact, if you would go ahead and spend the time that you have now that you're not arresting those peaceful drug users on arresting, oh, I don't know, murderers, rapists, arsonists, property vandals, you know, that would be okay with me too. I'm not anti-cop. I'm just anti-cops arresting people who've never actually committed a crime with a victim, with their complaint, where there's a complaining party. If there's a complaining party, then you've got a victim. If you've got a guy with a bag of pot in their pocket, there's no victim there. There's no complaining party. Leave those people alone. So let's go to your calls and thoughts. Also, want to let you know about saveitpurse.com. We talked earlier about how you can go to shop.freetalklive.com and shop through the Amazon links there, and Free Talk Live will get a portion of your purchase price when you do that. But if you've got Bitcoin, you'll want to actually do your shopping through saveatpurse.com. That's saveatpurse.com. And when you go through saveatpurse.com, you can save 20% on average if you're in the United States on your purchases there. Now, my average purchase is probably like 25% savings, because generally I'll go for 20, 25, 30% off. You get to choose what your discount is. The catch is you do have to have Bitcoin, though. So go to saveatpurse.com. Learn more about that there. Saveatpurse.com. As we go back to Bill. Bill, you said you were with the government for a long time. When the beginning of the war on drugs happened, you were there. You were working for the federal government. I think you said the Treasury Department. And you were kind of giving us some of your perspective on this whole thing. So please continue with your thoughts.
Okay. In my opinion, and I was at the top of the food chain with the Treasury Department, a federal agent, and it's been a total failure. It's been a total failure. Now, the successes have been keeping those steamships from coming into ports like New Orleans and Miami with entire holes full of pot from South America and Asia. I considered those successes because, you know, it was just over the top as far as the quantities went. But it should be looked at. Send the laws written. You go into Walgreens, buy it. For instance, if you get caught driving under the influence of pot, if they can develop a test for it, you just lost your license. No appeals, 10 years. And
that's a little excessive, but I can understand where you're coming from. I mean, it's certainly no one wants dangerous drivers out on the roads. However, would it surprise you to learn that in driving tests, people who are on cannabis are actually they're actually safer drivers than people who are sober drivers? Just by a statistically insignificant. They're far safer than drunk drivers. So if there's going to be a penalty, it shouldn't be as severe as drunk driving.
Well, you know, let me, you know, in full disclosure, I'm 73 years old, mm-hmm. and in 1970, I went to a party, and, everybody at the party in 1970 was smoking pot.
Yep, that's the same way today.
I tried it, and I only had 5 miles to go back home, and I drove 15 miles past my exit. And I was probably driving better than I ever drove in my life, but I had no idea where in the hell I was at.
Fair enough. That's a great story.
It scared me so damn bad, I never tried it again.
Yeah.
But, I hate anybody that says I grew up in the 1960s and I'm an angel. You know, I never, I never tried this or tried that, but I wasn't a believer in the pills. The psychedelics, the acid and all that. But, I figured a few guys sitting around smoking a joint, the ones I knew, they weren't going to go hurt anybody.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
They sat around and ate and got fat.
Bill, thanks so much for your call with your perspective tonight. I really appreciate it, hearing from somebody who's been around for a long time and has been involved on the inside of the war on drugs.
Life is common sense, and you've got to look at realities and go from there. You can't go from the Clint Eastwood Dirty Harry plot to to solve any problem, you know?
Thank you, Bill. Great call tonight. I really appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Marlena. She's in Indianapolis listening to WIBC. Hey, Marlena.
Hi. How are you this evening?
Great. Go ahead with your thoughts tonight.
Well, I've been listening to you, and I would like to offer some depth here. This will be one of your more in-depth calls.
Okay.
In substance abusers, there is a particular profile. And substance abuse usually correlates with another mental health diagnosis, major depression, bipolar, something of that nature.
Did you say often or usually?
Usually.
Usually. All right. Substance abuse. Okay.
Yes. Or addiction, however you prefer to call it.
But not use.
No, not use. Okay. Abuse.
Right. Thank you for clarifying that.
I just want to make sure.
Yeah. Not recreational use. Abuse.
Right.
But having worked on substance abuse units, inpatient hospitals, and mental health for many years, one of the parts of the profile is that most of these people who have had or are in substance in situations, trouble with the law for abusing substances, losing their house, losing their job, that this has become their way of life, on and on and on, have had trauma. And I don't know however to say it, but have had some kind of sexual abuse or molestation in their life, usually as children. So a lot of the people who are really hardcore substance abusers or hardcore alcoholics aren't doing it for recreation anymore. They're doing it to numb the pain.
Sure. Yeah, and there's actually an interesting study done. I wish I remember the doctor who did it, but the guy did a study about crack and meth users who were addicts, like abusers of these drugs, brought them into a hospital and, you know, sort of a clean environment and gave them the choice of like a nice raw rock of crack, like the best crack you could possibly get, medical grade crack or meth, one or the other, depending on what their addiction was. And then he would give them that choice or the choice of $20 in 3 weeks. And then every day they would have that choice, the choice of getting high or the choice of $20 at the end of the study, which was like a 3 week long study. And what he determined was that these people were actually able to make the rational choice of taking the $20 because it was a light at the end of the tunnel for them. These were people who had come from, very urban, terrible neighborhoods in bad shape.
They just didn't have hope.
They didn't have any hope in their life, and so they were absolutely using those drugs.
They're smoking desperation.
Right. They were using those drugs to numb the pain of their lives, but when their incentives changed, they changed. So it really, I think it was a really hope-filled study, actually. It was interesting. Kind of ties in with what you're saying.
Yeah. Well, and another thing, if we can move past the pot, I know here in Indianapolis, here in Indiana, nationwide, I believe there's a limit now on how doctors prescribe narcotics, hydrocodone, oxycodone, those types of painkillers, because now people have to go to pain doctors.
Mm-hmm.
So they aren't seeing as many abusers in their office because they can't write the prescriptions. But at least here in Indianapolis and in the state, heroin is a horrible problem.
Oh, yeah.
It's just exploded. And one of the theories is because the narcotics have become so difficult to obtain.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. Some people will get hooked on the narcotic substance and then they can't go back and get a refill because the DEA has insane rules that, you know, prevent these doctors. These doctors are scared to death of writing these prescriptions, basically, because they don't want to go to prison. They want to help their customers, but they don't want to go to prison. And so then those people will end up on the streets looking for heroin. You're absolutely right, Marlena. Thanks for your thoughts tonight. Really appreciate hearing from you. Let's get Tim in Wyoming on here. You got about 20 seconds, Tim. You get the final words. Go ahead.
Thanks a lot. I just wanted to mention that when Ben Carson is saying something about having an increase in the war on drugs and intensifying the war, he's talking about growing the government by leaps and bounds.
Yes, he is.
He was for the NSA, et cetera. I mean, he's not a good guy.
Nope, definitely not.
He's not a small government conservative.
No doubt about it. Tim, thanks for your call, man. Good way to wrap it up. I appreciate that. And we'll be back tomorrow night. If you didn't get in tonight, no problem. We're here 7 nights a week, live from 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time. Of course, you can grab us online anytime you like over at freetalklive.com. Enjoy your weekend.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, October 24th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.84 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,164 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $282. Antiwar.com reports at least 22 civilians were killed on Friday and another 40 wounded after a suicide bombing against a Shiite religious process in the Pakistani city of Jacobabad. 5 of the slain were children, and so far no group has claimed credit for the blast. The procession was commemorating the 9th day of Muharram, a part of the holiday Ashura, which is hugely important for Shiite Muslims. It is also commonly attacked by Sunni Islamist groups across the Middle East, particularly in Iraq, where massive pilgrimages are held. The processions in Pakistan, however, aren't nearly so big, but with ongoing sectarian violence in Pakistan, these smaller processions are still a popular target, despite efforts to make a major show of security by the Pakistani government. Such efforts to secure Shiite targets are common in Pakistan, but usually not very successful, as the various factions seem to find a way to hit these targets, with suicide attackers showing surprising effectiveness at infiltrating such gatherings and causing major casualties.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the Department of Justice on Friday said no charges are warranted against the Internal Revenue Service following a 2-year investigation into claims that the government's tax-collecting arm illegally targeted right-wing conservative groups seeking tax-exempt status. DOJ officials opened the probe in 2013 amid claims that the IRS was setting its sights on applications from conservative groups. The allegations said the agency singled out their applications for extra scrutiny while liberal groups met no such obstacle. On Friday, the DOJ announced it had closed the investigation after finding no evidence of illegal activity by the IRS, its employees, or former official Lois Lerner. Assistant Attorney General for Legislative Affairs Peter Kudzik wrote in an 8-page letter on Friday, Our investigation uncovered substantial evidence of mismanagement, poor judgment, and institutional inertia, leading to the belief by many tax-exempt applicants that the IRS targeted them based on their political viewpoints, but poor management is not a crime. We found no evidence that any IRS official acted on political, discriminatory, corrupt, or other inappropriate motives that would support a criminal prosecution. Kodzik also said the investigation conducted by the DOJ's Criminal and Civil Rights Division, the FBI, and the Treasury Department's Inspector General for Tax Administration found no evidence that any IRS official attempted to obstruct justice after the fact either. Lerner, who was held in contempt of Congress last year for refusing to answer the allegations, was placed on administrative leave during the investigation and ultimately resigned in September 2013. She was the head of the IRS's department responsible for processing tax-exempt applications.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports a proposed Alaska bridge that became a symbol of wasteful federal spending on politicians' pet projects has officially been scrapped a decade after the idea was first floated, according to state officials. Dubbed the Bridge to Nowhere, it would have connected the small city of Ketchikan to its airport on nearby Gravina Island, and it secured a $223 million earmark in 2005. Earmarks of nearly $450 million to help finance two proposed bridges produced cries of outrage from opponents who saw them as exemplifying federal waste. Alaska got the money in the end, but the earmarks were lifted. Jeremy Woodrow, Alaska Department of Transportation spokesman, said state officials had studied less expensive bridge options, but opted to pursue upgrading the ferry facilities for those making the 15-minute water commute. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The couple told reporters this week that they routinely urge their son Patrick to devote all of his time and resources to his improv comedy education.
We keep telling Patrick again and again that if you don't buckle down and start learning basic concepts like yes and the Herald now, nobody is going to take you seriously later in life.
He has to start thinking about this now.
The parents explained that he should try to get as much out of his improv training as possible by attending improv jams, forming a few indie teams, and doing as much bar prov as possible to keep himself warm for those upcoming Herald auditions.
The fact is, if Patrick were on stage with his fellow improvisers, and one of them were to play, say, a supervillain who's afraid of mice, Patrick wouldn't even be able to identify the game in that scene, let alone respond in a supportive way.
I gotta say, I had this internship at a law firm, but I quit to do a character workshop and a musical elective. I think this is really gonna pay off for me in the long run.
This is the Onion News Network.